twin receivers to the left and to the right. Daniels, the setback to the right of McMillan in the shotgun. On third and 8-10, direct snap to McMillan. And before we can snap the ball, the Longhorns going to be accused and be guilty of a false start. That's going to make it third down after the half the distance to the goal line penalty. That'll mark them back to the 4, and that'll make it third down and 14, and an auspicious start for the Longhorns after Colleyville punts on their initial possession. McMillan in the shotgun, Daniels to his right, twin receivers to the right and to the left. Now Denver Daniels moves to the left of McMillan in the shotgun. Direct snap, straight back in the pocket goes McMillan. He's throwing the out pattern. He's got a man. He overthrows number 25, Denver Daniels, in the flat. And that'll bring up fourth down and bring on Josh Stewart. And the Longhorn offense looking a little out of sync early. We understand we had some technical difficulties at the start of today's game. We want to apologize for that. You've missed nothing so far. 8:33 to go in the first. No score at AT&T Stadium. Longhorns, on their initial possession, will be in punt formation. It'll be number 84, Josh Stewart, to do the kicking. And he snaps the ball over Stewart's head, and it's a safety for Colleyville Heritage. The Panthers lead 2-0. So, a very auspicious start for the Division II's number one seed, the 8-6A district champion Cedar Hill Longhorns, as a opening safety gives Colleyville an early 2-0 lead, and the Longhorns will be forced to kick from their own 20-yard line.
And good job by Colleyville's defense, able to hold the Cedar Hill Longhorns into their own territory. They tried to get the ball going on the ground about Daniels and Ware, wasn't really doing much. And then on third down, a false start by the Horns backed them up even farther. They kind of have some bracket coverage on Lodge, wasn't able to get it out of there.
Today's game between the Cedar Hill Longhorns and the Colleyville Heritage Panthers is broadcast live on 1480 KBDX and Champion Sports Radio. Longhorns now will be punting from their own 20-yard line, and in fact, they're not going to punt. They are going to kick the ball off the tee, and it'll be Brooks Routh. Bill Howard here along with my broadcast partners Cam Bolin and Cody Krim, bringing you this first round playoff game between the 5-5 Colleyville Heritage Panthers and the 9-2 8-6A district champion Cedar Hill Longhorns. Longhorns trail 2-0, and the free kick is going to be fielded by Colleyville at their own 25, up to the 30, 35, across the 40 and out to the 42-yard line. And it's going to be number 10, Ryan Felipe, on the return. And for the second possession today for Colleyville Heritage, they'll start first down and 10 from their own 43-yard line. And Cody, it's one of those situations where the Longhorns, hoping to get off to a fast start today, unable to do so as a result of the errant snap that gives a safety to Colleyville Heritage.
Yeah, but something I really did like to see was the defensive possession they had earlier. Earlier in the defense has looked very good against Colleyville, forcing a 3-and-out. If they can do that here, maybe get some better field position for the Horns.
On first down, they run the jet sweep from left to right, and up near the 45-yard line, the running back, number 10, Ryan Felipe. In fact, they'll put him down at the 46. That'll give him a 4-yard gain, make it second down, make it 3, make it second down and 7 as the jet sweep from right to left nets Colleyville Heritage 3 yards.
And good job by this defensive 4-man front so far. Quentin Jones really doing
on
a great
second
job
down,
getting off the ball.
Inside handoff is faked. Anderson's going to keep it across the 45 and get to the 47-yard line. It's going to be a pickup of only one, and Kalen Jackson in on the tackle for the Cedar Hill Longhorns, but it was Kyle Goss, 22, that got there first. That's going to make it third down and 7 for Colleyville Heritage. They'll snap the ball from their own 46-yard line. Left hash mark, they move from right to left. 7:24 to go in the first. Colleyville leading 2-0. Direct snap and an inside handoff to DeMarco Corbin. He's going to get across the 50 and down to the 46-yard line. And that's going to be close to a first down. In fact, it's going to be enough for a first down for Colleyville Heritage.
Good tough running there by Colleyville. Really surprised they come out on fourth and long there with a dive up the middle. Great call from the Colleyville Heritage sideline. Cedar Hill really need to stick to their ground game on defense.
First down, 6:55 to go in the clock. Runs inside handoff is to the first back, 27. And that's going to be DeMarco Corbin, and the Longhorns are going to take him down for a loss back at the 49-yard line. He'll lose two, and that'll make it second down and 12. And for the Longhorns, Kyle Goss came in to clean it up, but number 15, Travis Gibson, the middle linebacker, was there first. 6:30 to go in the first period at AT&T Stadium, Division II, Round 1. Colleyville Heritage surprisingly leading Cedar Hill here early, 2-0, after the Longhorns have an errant snap out of their own end zone in a punting situation. Direct snap to Anderson on second down. He rolls to the near side. He's looking. He's going to throw the ball deep downfield. They got a man wide open, and it's a touchdown.
And number nine, Camden Arnold, able to get by his the free safety over the top. Virtually wide open for an easy pitch and catch for Colleyville Heritage.
Cedar Hill's defensive woes can continue. That is a 48-yard touchdown pass from quarterback Trevor Anderson.
Yeah, and a bit uncharacteristic of Bradley. There was a busted coverage. I mean, we really can't blame it on any one particular player, but Bradley was the only defender within really 5 yards of the receiver as he caught a touchdown and strode in for an easy TD for Colleyville Heritage.
That'll give Colleyville Heritage an 8-0 lead with 6:04 to go in the first.
And a lot of confidence.
And a lot of confidence. You're absolutely right, Cam. The extra point attempt is forthcoming. The kick is down. The hold is down. The kick is up. And it is good. And with 6:04 to go in the first quarter, a shocker early at AT&T Stadium. Colleyville Heritage 8, Cedar Hill nothing. Cedar Hill Longhorn football on KBDX 1440. We'll be back in a moment.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
On KBXDAM 1480, you're listening to Cedar Hill Longhorn High School football. Colleyville Heritage surprisingly jumping out to an early 9-0 lead against the Longhorns. Colleyville Heritage will kick off from their own 40-yard line. Back deep for the Longhorns, number 10, Jalen Jackson, and number 25, Denver Daniels. 6:04 to go in the first. Glad you're with us on KBXD 1480 and the Champion Sports Radio Network. A line drive kick is going to carry Denver Daniels 8 yards deep in the end zone. He starts to come out but takes a knee, and the Longhorns will have it first down and 10. From their own 25-yard line to begin their second series. And, Cam, it was an auspicious first series for the Longhorn offense.
Yeah, it's really been kind of an inauspicious start for the Horns so far, as Colleyville Heritage has found success moving the football on the ground and a little bit through the air. Obviously, they had the big play for the touchdown. Cedar Hill will just need to kind of settle down and tighten things up.
First down and 10 for the Longhorns from their own 25. Ika Cedric Ware, the I-back behind Justin McMillan in the shotgun. Twins left, single receiver to the right. Play action pass. They throw it out to a wide open Denver Daniels. He gets up to the 30 and steps across and out of bounds at the 30-yard line. A pickup of 5 on the bubble screen to Denver Daniels.
And that's a new wrinkle that we've seen for Coach Glaze. We haven't seen that play action bubble screen out to Denver Daniels. Nice game.
Second down and 5. Longhorns go NASCAR offense. Idem Wanye, the tight end, strong to the left. Twin receivers to the right. Daniels, the running back behind McMillan on second and 5. Direct snap to McMillan. They hand it off inside to D-Square. He's going to get up to about the 33-yard line. He'll be about 2 yards short of a first down before he's knocked to the ground.
And that was by number two, Nick Felix, coming up from his defensive back position.
Third down and two for the Longhorns. In the Wildcat, it's Aka Cedric Ware. He's going to be stopped short of the first down. He's going to be a half yard short on a direct snap. Ware will be taken down about a half yard short, and it's fourth down and inches for the Longhorns. And look at this. Longhorns going to go with 5:15 to go in the first and trailing 9-0. Ware in the Wildcat formation again. Ware's going to keep it straight up the pipe. Got it all the way up near the 40-yard line. A five-yard gain on fourth and inches for Aka Cedric Ware. Joey McGuire and Michael Glaze rolling the dice early here at AT&T Stadium, finding themselves behind by a score of 9-0. 4:50 to go here in the first. Longhorns moving from left to right, now have a new set of downs. Twin receivers to the left. Right. Daniels, the I-back, gets the inside handoff on first down, gets some running room across the 45 all the way up near the 50-yard line goes Denver Daniels. That's going to be a gain of 11 and another Cedar Hill Longhorn first down, and the Longhorns go NASCAR. Twins to the left, Edomwanye strong to the right as the tight end. Daniels remains the running back behind McMillan. They hand it off. No, they fake it to McMillan, throw it out to Lodge on the screen. He makes one man miss, 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, and he's finally run out of bounds on a touchdown saving tackle by Colleyville Heritage, and they're going to mark him down. I believe they say he went out of bounds around the 25-yard line, a 25-yard pitch and catch on the bubble screen from Justin McMillan to DeMarcus Lodge.
And they're putting a great move on number 15, Daylon Brown, the defensive back for Colleyville Heritage. Lodge making him miss. Great job of blocking
first
on the outside,
down and
too.
10. They fake the reverse straight back in the pocket. They're throwing it long downfield, and the ball's going to be intercepted in the end zone by Colleyville Heritage's number two, Nick Felix, the defensive back. They faked the reverse, and they tried to throw the deep ball on the fly route down the left sideline, but the safety, Nick Felix, comes up with the interception. With the score, Colleyville Heritage 9, Cedar Hill nothing. Cedar Hill Longhorn football on the Champion Sports Radio Network. We'll be back in a moment.
Buford Roofing and Construction is a family-owned company you can trust. Buford Roofing specializes in roofing replacement and repair for the outside of your home or business and radiant barriers and insulation for the inside. They use top-quality materials, professionally trained crews, and guarantee total customer satisfaction. When you use Buford Roofing and Construction, you can consider yourself protected. They're online at BufordRoofing.com or call 817-329-ROOF.
Back at AT&T Stadium, on a first down play after the interception, Colleyville Heritage picks up only a yard. It's second and 9 from the 21. Anderson fakes the inside handoff. No, he actually hands it off to Corbin, and Corbin's going to get across the 20 and out to the 23. A pickup of only 2 and a big 3rd and 7. The Longhorns had moved the ball all the way down the field before Justin McMillan's pass off a fake reverse was intercepted by Nick Felix. And since that turnover, after two plays, Colleyville Heritage has 3rd down and 7 from the 23. Anderson straight back in the pocket, throws the out route, got a man wide open, and it's complete up near the 30-yard line, but he's going to be shot stopped at the 28 by 26 Floyd Smith for the Longhorns. And that's going to bring up 4th down and 2, and Colleyville Heritage is going to punt.
Now, great hustle play, way to get to the edge. More of a bend but don't break defense for the Horns. Now they're going to get the ball back.
In punt formation, number 37, Stephen Bodish. Back deep for the Longhorns, Denver Daniels into Marcus Lodge. Bodish just gets a high end-over-end kick that's short. It's going to be fielded by Daniels on the bounce at the 50, up to the 45, makes one man miss before he's run out of bounds at the 42-yard line of Colleyville Heritage. Bodish's punt was a low line drive kick with not much distance. A punt of only 32 yards, but a good return for Denver Daniels, who brings the Longhorns back to the 42-yard line of Colleyville Heritage. They'll be 1st down and 10.
Longhorns, on their last possession, can move the ball well, but were unable to get points. This time they start in great field position. Josh Stewart goes wide to the left for the Longhorns.
And of course, it'll be critical for McMillan not to turn the ball over throughout the game.
Avery Davis in at quarterback.
Avery Davis is in at quarterback for the Longhorns, the sophomore. He's going to keep it up the middle, and he's going to get down to the 40-yard line, a gain of three. We'll try to see what's going on with Justin McMillan. If it's
no, he's
injury.
He's on the field ahead of him, wideout.
Ah, okay. All right. So Avery Davis, they give the sophomore, the quarterback of the future for the Cedar Hill Longhorns, a little bit of playing time here, Cam, and he picks up 4 yards on his first carry, makes it second down and six from the 36.
And our scout, Bill Howard, has watched him play some at JV, says he has a cannon.
Great prospects. It's Avery Davis. On second down, they hand it off inside to Aka Cedric Ware, and he plows his way from the 40 down to around the 35. I actually said they were on the 36. That was my mistake. Longhorns were actually on the 41, so Ware's going to pick up about 5 yards, and that's going to bring up a third down and about 3.5 for the Longhorns from the Colleyville 36. Wide receivers to either side, Ware, the running back behind McMillan. Direct snap to McMillan, inside handoff again to Ware. He's going to pick his way up to the 30, 25, all the way down to the 22-yard line. Longhorn football picks up a big first down. You're listening to us on KPXD Dallas, the powerhouse of North Texas. And Aka Cedric Ware was the powerhouse on that run. He takes it all the way inside the 25-yard line. On first down, inside handoff again to Ware from McMillan. And this time he only picks up a couple, but there's a flag down. And let's hear the call.
Those types of penalties kill an offense, especially when there's a gain and you have a little bit of momentum going.
Longhorn's going to be backed up 10. The ball is going to be moved back to the 32-yard line of Colleyville Heritage, and the Longhorns will be looking at a first down. McMillan in the shotgun. Inside handoff to Daniels. Daniels kicks it outside to the 30. 25, 20. Makes the man miss it to 20 and gets all the way down to the 18-yard line. A 15-yard gain on first down for Denver Daniels. As we go inside, 30 seconds left in the first period of play. The clock has stopped as they move the chain.
Great job blocking there by Kobe Udwanye, getting out front, leading the way for Daniels to pick up that huge gain. Now second, manageable.
Much more manageable now. Let's make it second down and 7. They'll snap it from the 19-yard line. McMillan in the shotgun, full house backfield. Direct snap to Justin. He fakes it, takes it straight up the middle of the 15, down to the close to the 10. They'll mark him at the 11, but that should be enough for a Cedar Hill Longhorn first down with 20 seconds to go here in the first period of play. A first period dominated to this point by Colleyville Heritage. They lead 9-0, surprisingly, over the District 8 6A champion Longhorn. That's a Cedar Hill first down on first and 10 from the 11. Full house backfield. McMillan inside handoff to Cedric Ware to the 10. He makes the first man miss, gets all the way down to the 5. And the Longhorns now, Cody, starting to play a little smash mouth football on what will be the final play of the first quarter. With the score, Colleyville Heritage 9, Cedar Hill 0. Cedar Hill Longhorn football on KBXD 1460. And Champion Sports Radio will be back in a moment.
There's a time and a place for everything.
As you'll see, projections for the next quarter are...
He shoots, he scores! 2 points for team middle management.
The office is not one of them.
Jack, can I see you in my office?
No pouting, it's your ball, let's see what you got.
But Whirly Ball is.
For corporate events, team building, and private parties, Whirly Ball in Hearst and Plano is electric fun. Test your skills on the arcade games. Zip around in your Whirly Bug for a Whirly Ball competition. Or play the most affordable laser tag in the city. Learn more at whirlyball.info.
Back at AT&T Stadium, thanks for joining us on KBXD. Dallas, the powerhouse of North Texas. Mack Hike Ford in DeSoto, where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling on I-35E between Pleasant Run and Bell Line Road in DeSoto. our sponsor for today's first round Division II matchup between the District 8-6A champion Cedar Hill Longhorns and the Division II number 2 seed and heavy underdogs here, Colleyville Heritage. And when the Longhorns begin the second period of play, they find themselves behind 9-0. But the Longhorns also have a second down and 4 from the Colleyville Heritage 5-yard line. McMillan has a full house backfield and she's in the shotgun. He's flanked by Denver Daniels and Elijah Moore. Like a Cedric Ware, the I-back. On second down, they hand it off inside to Aka Cedric. Big hole up the middle. Touchdown, Cedar Hill, Longhorns. And just like that, the Longhorns marched 42 yards after a punt return that was gives the Longhorns great field position.
And number 72, Randy Christian, All-State offensive tackle, just clearing the way for Ware there. He was out last week doing a tremendous job on that play.
Brooks Rouse's extra point attempt is line driven through. We'll take it. 11:54 to go. Longhorns on the board. Heritage 9, Cedar Hill 7. Champion Sports Radio and KBXD Dallas. Longhorn football will be back in a moment.
Point of Origin Design is your one-stop shop for all your apparel, promotional, event, or team uniform needs. Point of Origin Design is a full-service design and logo creation company that offers a wide variety of imprintable and embroidered products. With competitive pricing and quality work, you can't go wrong with Point of Origin Design. It's always best to start at the right point. So visit them online at pointoforigindesign.com. Let them help you plan your next promotional item or design your next t-shirt. That's online at pointoforigindesign.com.
Back at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, KBXD and Champion Sports Radio bringing you Division II, Round 1, 6A Texas High School playoff action. The Longhorns of Cedar Hill trailing 9-0, marks 42 yards in 7 plays for their initial score, and now it's a 9-7 game, and Brooks Ralph for the Longhorns will be kicking off. Back deep, number 10, Ryan Felipe, awaiting, and the Longhorns kick a short pooch kick. It's fielded up at the 34-yard line, and a fair catch made by number 2, Nick Felix, who already has an interception to his credit today. But that's where the Panthers will start, first down and 10, moving from left to right. Ladies and gentlemen, Buford Roofing and Construction. When you use Buford Roofing and Construction, you can consider yourself protected, and customer satisfaction is always guaranteed. Buford Roofing and Construction, a proud sponsor of today's Texas High School playoff football. On first and 10 from the 34, twins to the left, one to the right. The running back, Corbin, to the left of the quarterback, Anderson. He gets the inside handoff. He's going to be across the 35 and out to the 36. We'll give him about 2.5 yards. Kyle Goss, the linebacker for Cedar Hill, in on the tackle. Goss having a very good game early on.
And Kyle Goss, obviously one of my favorite players, always plays really hard. Great job.
On second down, they run the jet sweep to the left. Cutting it up inside for about a 3-yard gain will be number 14, Jamari Williams, the junior running back. And the Longhorns, number 4, Richard Moore, the All-State linebacker, making the tackle for the Longhorns. And that's going to set up a third down and about 6 for Colleyville Heritage. They operate from their own 36-yard line from the right hash mark. Direct snap to Anderson. He rolls near side. The left-hander sets up, throws it out in the flat. The ball's incomplete, but there is a flag down at the 36-yard line, so we'll have to wait and see if it goes against Colleyville Heritage. The Longhorns are going to force a punting situation out of the Panthers, but we'll have to wait and see the call. It is an illegal motion penalty against Colleyville. That'll be declined. That'll bring up a 4th down and 6, and on for Colleyville Heritage will be Stephen Bodish, the 6-foot, 175-pound senior punter. And in deep return formation, rather, I should say, for the Longhorns, be number 25, Denver Daniels. And Cody, he's joined back there, I believe, by Jalen Jackson or DeMarcus Lodge.
DeMarcus Lodge is who they brought off.
A high spiraling kick is going to be fielded by Daniels. No, he's going to let it hit. It bounces into 30. Longhorns get away from it. It takes a little bit of a Cedar Hill bounce back to the 34. That's where the Longhorns, with 10:44 to go in the half, will set up shop first down and 10. Cody, how important for the Longhorns to have gotten that last score, getting some momentum going?
The mid support portions, Bill. It really is important for Cedar Hill to really get some confidence built up, kind of get their feet wet in what they're doing. Really had some inauspicious starts on their first two possessions. Hopefully that'll get the offense more in the flow of the game.
First down and 10 for the Longhorns. They'll operate from their own 33-yard line from the left hash mark, moving from right to left. Wide receivers to either side, double tight end set. Aka Cedric Ware, the running back. McMillan going to give it to Ware on the counter coming right. He's going to be taken down for about a 4-yard loss. And great defensive recognition by Colleyville Heritage. Cedar Hill's bread and butter play, the counter tray, and it was number 90, Jason Williams, the 290-pound senior defensive lineman who made an outstanding play to drop Ware for a loss and make it second down and 15. Twin receivers to the right, H-back strong to the right. Direct snap to McMillan. Inside handoff to Ware, and Ware's going to be taken down at the line of scrimmage. And it's number 35, Jake Moore, the senior linebacker.
And Jake Moore and really the entire front seven of Colleyville Heritage really doing a great job imposing their will and not being defeated by the Longhorn offense.
Well, they're daring Cedar Hill to throw the football right now. And now Cedar Hill's in a position where they must. Third and 15 from the 28-yard line. McMillan in the shotgun, trips to the right, one to the left. McMillan changing the play at the line of scrimmage. Direct snap, he'll throw straight back in the pocket. Excellent protection. He pulls it down. Now he's going to run to the 30, to the 35, up near the 40, but he'll be 3 yards short of the first down. Justin McMillan can't pull the trigger, and that's going to make it fourth down, and the Longhorns will be looking at a probable punt situation.
And it looks like there may be a little hesitation from the Cedar Hill sideline that they may be going for it, but no, now they do bring the punting unit on.
Well, you never know with the riverboat gambler Joey McGuire.
And McMillan's still on the field.
And now they leave.
Longhorn's going to go with McMillan on the field on fourth down and 3 from their own 40. They're going to go. McMillan in the shotgun. Motion across the formation. They hand it off inside to Ware. Ware coming right to the 40. Runs over a player up to the 45-yard line. First down. Oh, my goodness gracious. That is some confidence in your offensive machine, Dan.
Yeah, really a lot of confidence in your offensive line and sending a message to your team that we're not going to back down and we will impose our will no matter how many guys they put in the box.
A huge fourth down conversion gives the Longhorns a first and 10 from the 44, their own 44. Inside handoff, Daniels to the 45, up near the 48. He's still going across midfield, all the way down to the 44-yard line. Up Colleyville Heritage goes Denver Daniels. Can he show the power of Aka Cedric Ware right there?
Yeah, not often that you see a guy with Denver Daniels' size able to drag a pile of defenders, but Denver Daniels got an extra 4 yards after he
had Longhorn first down, brought to you by Matt Hack. In the soda. High formation, where the running back behind McMillan gets the inside hand off to the 40, makes one man miss, gets down to about the 39. Correction, that was Denver Daniels on the carry, not on the Cedric Ware. Daniels now going out of the game, Ware checking back in.
And for our listeners just joined us, DeMarcus Lodge still without a pass. Colleyville Heritage doing a really good job of bracket coveraging. Sometimes they just straight up put two guys on him, really doing a good job. Cedar Hill sticking to the ground game so far.
Well, you can't stop DeMarcus. You can only hope to contain him. Second down and 6 from the 40. Inside handoff to Ware. He bounces it to the outside, waiting for a blocker that never comes. And Ware's going to be pulled down on the 38. He fumbled the ball, and the ball is recovered by Colleyville Heritage. And I thought, like I said, well, Ware might have been down there, but the referee said no, the ball came out.
Yeah, I think the defender from Heritage did a good job of tackling the ball and not the man.
We look at it on the instant replay, and the ball definitely came out before Ware was down. An excellent call by the officials. Longhorn's second mistake of the afternoon.
will give Colleyville Heritage the ball first and 10 on their own 38. 7:19 to go in the first half here on KBXD. Dallas, the powerhouse of North Texas, bringing you Cedar Hill Longhorn playoff football. Longhorns trailing 9-7. Colleyville Heritage will move from left to right. The quarterback, Trevor Anderson, and before the play can be run, Colleyville will take a timeout. So will we. KBXD 1460 and Cedar Hill Longhorn football on the Champion Sports Radio Network. We'll be back in a moment.
In Command Broadcasting, a sports TV broadcasting and marketing company. In Command Broadcasting provides a wide array of turnkey video production and streaming services. In Command services include filming of sporting events, season highlights, school graduations, corporate infomercials, and documentaries. In Command streams your sporting event or company function over the internet live or on demand. Call 972-851-7888 to raise the energy of your next event. In Command Broadcasting, 972-851-7888.
Back at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, the Cedar Hill Longhorns find themselves with 7:19 left in the first half of this round one, Division II, 6A, Texas State High School playoff matchup with Colleyville Heritage. They're finding them going a little rougher than they expected. Colleyville Heritage leading 9-7, has the ball first down at 10. On the Longhorn 38, they go trips to the right. Now motion across the formation from right to left. Anderson, the quarterback, straight back in the pocket. Looking, looking. He's throwing the ball deep downfield. Got a man down there, but the ball's overthrown. DeMarcy Perry had great coverage for the Longhorns. The pass intended for number 27, the do-everything running back, DeMarco Corbett. That's going to bring up second down and 10 for Colleyville Heritage.
And Richard Moore there coming up from his linebacker position on kind of a delayed blitz, getting some pressure up the middle. That's going to be imperative for the Longhorns to continue to do this afternoon.
Straight back in the pocket on second down. They're trying to set up the screen. Anderson can't get it to the running back in the left flat. The ball falls incomplete, and that's going to make it third down and 7.
And Caleb Ray was oh so close to maybe even having a pick six had he been able to have his head on a swivel. He did a good job of playing the screen, but just wasn't able to find the football and earn a turnover.
I think I said it was third down and 7. That's my mistake. After the two incompletions, of course, they have gained no yards, so Colleyville Heritage has a third down and 10 from their own 38. Trip receivers to the right. Now motion across the formation. Anderson straight back in the pocket will throw. He's throwing it deep down the field. He's got a man down there, but he overthrows him. The ball was intended for number 8, Jackson Zeladon.
And good bracket coverage by Kalon Jackson, playing trail technique. And you had Avery Bradley the second doing a good job over the top at the safety position.
That's going to bring up a fourth down situation for Colleyville Heritage. The Panthers will be looking to punt the football back deep for the Longhorns. I believe it's 18 to Marcus Lodge. Number 37, Stephen Bodish in punt formation. He will receive the snap at his own 25. Colleyville Heritage spreading their punt team out all over. Here it comes. It's a line drive kick. It's going to bounce, and Lodge is going to pick the ball up under duress at the 20, and he gets up to about the 24-yard line, and that's where the Longhorns will take over. Trailing 9-7 with 6:51 to go here in the first half. That's a very, very chancy play by Superman, DeMarcus Lodge. But when you wear the S on your chest, you can make those kind of gambles. And the Longhorns retain possession. They'll have it first down and 10 from their own 24-yard line. Longhorns will snap it from the right hash mark. McMillan in the shotgun. Denver Daniels, the sole setback behind McMillan. H-back strong to the right, twin receivers to the left. Inside handoff to Daniels, coming right to the 25, to the 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, and here he goes. B square to the 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Denver Daniels, Cedar Hill Longhorns. Make it 76 yards on the run, and Mr. Daniels has given the Cedar Hill Longhorns their first lead of the day, 13-9.
And Denver Daniels there throwing at least 3 stiff arms, really running tough today, as we've already seen earlier in the game. He's kept the legs moving all the way down the field for a 75-yard touchdown run.
Brooks Ralph on for the extra point. Denver Daniels ignites the Cedar Hill Longhorn crowd. Brooks Ralph makes it a little bit more exciting with a line drive extra point. With 6:38 to go in the first half, Cedar Hill 14, Colleyville Heritage 9, Longhorn football on KBXD and Champion Sports Radio. We'll be back in a moment.
Stay up on all the latest news about the teams you care about and know when your favorite games are on the air thanks to Champion Sports Radio social media. Either follow at Champion Sports on Twitter or like our Facebook page at facebook.com/Champion Sports Radio, and you will know what time your game starts, who was named Player of the Week, or what your school's alumni are doing in college. That's on Twitter at Champion Sports and facebook.com/Champion Sports Radio, your home for championship social media.
Back at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, the Cedar Hill Longhorns, on the strength of a 76-yard touchdown run by number 25 Denver Daniels, has taken the lead over Colleyville Heritage 14-9. Brooks Ralph set to kick off. Back deep, number 10, Ryan Felipe for Colleyville Heritage. There's a high, long kick that drives Felipe back into the end zone. He fumbles the ball, will pick it up in the end zone, and will take it down. And that will be a touchback for Colleyville Heritage. They will set up shop. First down and 10 from their own 25. 6:38 to go. And, Cam, it's the lightning-quick offense of Cedar Hill, the explosiveness of Denver Daniels, that takes care of Cedar Hill's quick scoring drive.
And it has to be disheartening to Colleyville Heritage, because they're scheming to stop the run of Cedar Hill, but players like DeMarcus Lodge and this offensive line from Cedar Hill have done a great job blocking on the interior and the perimeter, allowing the backs long touchdown game.
First down and 10 from the 25, Anderson with an eye back behind him on first down, play action pass. Anderson rolls to his left. He's going to throw it out of bounds. Nobody open there. That's going to make it second down and 10. Good coverage by the Longhorn defense. Pass was intended for number 27, DeMarco Corbin.
Also, good pressure by number 22, Kyle Goss, along with number 54 again, Quentin Jones, getting great pressure on the quarterback there.
The left-handed quarterback, Trevor Anderson, took a shot after he threw that ball, and he's moving his right shoulder around. He is a southpaw, though, so it shouldn't have much effect. Second down and 10 from the 25. Bubble screen to the outside is complete up to the 30, near the 30-yard line, goes number 8, Jackson Zeladon. And for the Longhorns, number 4, Richard Moore, makes a good defensive stop to bring up a key third down and 6.
Yeah, Moore recognizing that as soon as the ball snapped, sprinted out to the wideout position of Colleyville Heritage and brought down the runner.
Trips to the left, tight end strong to the right, one back in the backfield. Anderson will throw on third down. Straight back, here comes the Longhorn pressure, and Richard Moore gets it. He sacks it back at the 21-yard line for an 8-yard loss, and Richard Moore, the high school All-American, makes the play.
Man, Kevin Sumlin is going to be happy to have that kid next year in SEC.
Well, Texas A&M, you got one coming, baby. And his name is Richard Moore. Moore taking down Anderson back at the 21, brings up a fourth down for Colleyville Heritage, and DeAndre Bradley, making his first appearance since his injury 3 weeks ago, is back in return formation. The punt by Bodfish goes off the side of his foot. Oh, my goodness. That's going to end up being a very, very short punt. It goes out of bounds. They're going to mark that ball up near the 40-yard line, maybe even inside. No, right at the 41-yard line of Cedar Hill. Oh, my goodness.
And the punter is going to take the blame on that. But he really did a great job of just fielding the football because it was high and to the left.
An 18-yard punt for Bodfish, and you're right, Cam. Bodfish saved Colleyville Heritage some points right there. That ball was headed over his head on the snap. But the Longhorns, with 5:20 to go in the first half, leading 14-9, have a first down and 10 at the Colleyville 41. Daniels, the running back, will be to the right of McMillan. Twin receivers to the left, tight end strong to the right. Longhorns move from right to left. They fake lodge the jet sweep. They throw the screen to the outside to Elijah Moore. And, boy, what a great defensive play back at the 45-yard line by number 26, Ja'Cory Williams, to come up and sniff that screen out and drop Moore for a 3-yard loss.
And really just came unblocked after the pass was completed to Moore. Great job coming up from his backer position.
Second down and 13 for the Longhorns from the middle of the field. McMillan in the shotgun. Inside handoff to Aka Cedric Ware, and he's going to be taken down after a gain of only one to the 44. And what looked very promising just a moment ago, Cam, now it's a third and 13 from the 44-yard line for the Longhorns.
Yeah, there aren't many plays in your playbook with third and 13, but we'll look and see if Lodge can get a ball a little bit deep here.
Well, the Longhorns may be looking at two-down territory here also, given that they're over the opponent's 50. Trips to the right, one to the left. Ball on the left hash mark. Longhorns moving from right to left. McMillan in the shotgun on third and 13 will throw straight back in the pocket. Great protection. Looking. Now he's going to pull it down and run. 40, 35. And he's taken down at the 33-yard line. That's going to be about 2 yards short of the first down.
And he was McMillan was looking for Lodge that time on an out route, but he was well covered by Colleyville Heritage. So McMillan did the smart thing, pulled it down, and got his 3 yards.
Fourth down and two. The Longhorns will go from the Wildcat formation. Aka Cedric Ware takes the snap, looking for running room. It's going to be close. He's going to get down close to the 30-yard line, and I think that's going to be enough for a Cedar Hill Longhorn first down. For the second time today, Cam, Longhorns go Wildcat formation with Aka Cedric Ware on short yardage, and Aka Cedric makes it pay.
Yeah, take advantage of the kid's vision, because that is one of his strongest assets.
That first down and 10 brought to you by Mack Hike Ford in DeSoto, where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling. On I-35E between Pleasant Run and Beltline Road in DeSoto. On first down, Longhorns hand it off inside to Ware. He's going to be taken down right at the line of scrimmage. And it's number 35, Jake Moore, for Colleyville Heritage, having a super game so far, Cam.
Yeah, I mean, really, Heritage is doing a good job. It's just Cedar Hill making a few more plays here and there offensively. And then we do have a flag on the field.
So it looks like a flag came in after the play that's going to be against Cedar Hill.
Still after the play.
I get Randy Christian after the play for a 15-yard penalty, personal foul, and that really is going to cramp the Longhorn style because it was after the play, and that means it's going to be now second down. And the Longhorns are going to take a timeout. So will we. 3:15 to go in the half. Longhorns 14, Heritage 9. Cedar Hill Longhorn football on the Champion Sports Radio and KBXD. We'll be back in a moment.
Writer Gerald Early said that when they study our civilization 2,000 years from now, there will only be three things that Americans will be known for: the Constitution, baseball, and jazz music. GDYO's Jazz Institute provides young musicians in North Texas the opportunity to learn what it means to be a jazz musician through weekly technique classes and combo rehearsals with professional jazz musicians. From the first note to the final round of applause, GDYO Jazz Institute concerts will amaze and delight both hardcore jazz cats and new fans alike. Learn more about the truly original American art form through the GDYO Jazz Institute online at gdyo.org/jazz.
Back at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, Division II, Round 1, playoff action between Cedar Hill and Colleyville Heritage sees the Longhorns leading Colleyville 14-9 with 3:15 to go in the second quarter of play. Longhorns, after the 15-yard penalty, will be looking at a second down and 25. They go trips to the right, twins to the left. Moving from right to left, McMillan alone in the shotgun. Three-man front for Colleyville. They drop eight defensive backs. McMillan on the quarterback draw to the 40, to the 35, to the 30. 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Cedar Hill Longhorns. Oh, Justin McMillan was the magic man.
And the Marcus Lodge just absolutely pancaked Nick Felix there, the defensive back for Colleyville, opening up a huge hole. For McMillan, just a great play and great physicalness on the outside by his receiving corps.
The Longhorns up 20-9 are going to go for two. McMillan stays on the field after his 45-yard touchdown run. Colleyville Heritage has given up two huge plays to the Cedar Hill Longhorns. Denver Daniels, 76-yard touchdown run, and the touchdown run by quarterback Justin McMillan of 45 yards has staked the Longhorns to a 20-9 lead, and they're going to go for two. Longhorns going to do it from the left hash mark. Jalen Jackson is the running back behind McMillan with running backs on either side. McMillan going to throw it on the throwback, looking for McMillan, and it's dropped in the end zone. They tried the throwback where they handed the ball to Jalen Jackson going from left to right. Jackson tried to throw a strike in the corner of the end zone, but McMillan couldn't hold on.
Yeah, McMillan made the catch a little bit harder than he had to. Because you can tell he doesn't play receiver too often. Because instead of trying to just catch it over his shoulder, he spit back around to his right. And then he kind of fell back and lost his balance.
With 3:05 to go in the first half, the Cedar Hill Longhorns, on the strength of a 45-yard touchdown run from quarterback Justin McMillan, have increased their lead to 20-9. Longhorns spotted Colleyville Heritage 9 points in the first quarter, Cam, but since then, the Cedar Hill offensive machine has taken hold.
Yeah, the Horns offensive line should get all the credit in the world, along with the receivers on the outside, because they've opened up huge lanes and holes. And really, Justin McMillan has done a good job of being patient and not forcing footballs aside from the interception. Since then, he's made great decisions and been able to run and scramble. It's not there.
Brooks Ralph set to kick off. Back deep for Colleyville Heritage will be number 10, Ryan Felipe. Cody down 9-0 were the Longhorns, but it looks like they've awakened now and things are back to normal.
Yeah, the Horns have definitely found their rhythm. If they're able to get a stop by Colleyville here, they could put a huge lead on the board going into halftime.
Deep kick going to number 10, Ryan Felipe, and Felipe almost came out of the end zone with the ball. He got very near the goal line.
I think he may have gotten a little bit of a good call, and his teammates kind of telling him about it right now. The refs may have let him off the hook.
I tell you, he had the ball in his left hand, so if he probably didn't cross the plane, but he came extremely close to stepping out of bounds. Out of the back side of the end zone with the football, and that would have been a safety for Cedar Hill. So a fortuitous break for Colleyville Heritage. They dodge a bullet. They have a first down and 10 from the Cedar Hill 25. Number 27, DeMarco Corbin, the setback. Anderson fakes to Corbin, throws it out in the flat. Got a man wide open up at the 40-yard line. It's number 3, Max Crosby, the tight end, and the Longhorns flat blew a coverage right there.
Yeah, we've seen that a couple times when the Horns go away from the zero coverage and into zone, where there may be a man left uncovered and someone escapes his zone trying to make a play.
Longhorns going to have to get better at covering tight ends and backs. On first down, Anderson in the shotgun hands it off to Corbin coming right. The Longhorn defense strings it out. Corbin turns the corner to the 40 all the way up to the 46-yard line. That's great running by DeMarco Corbin as the Longhorns had great defense. Strung it out, but Corbin, using his speed and power, got around the corner.
Yeah, that's a great example of giving maximum effort as Corbin ran through at least 3 Cedar Hill Longhorn defenders.
Eric Sutton had a chance to make a stop in the backfield, and Corbin ran right through it. It's going to be second down and 2 after Corbin's 8-yard gain. He's to the right of Anderson in the shotgun. Direct snap to Anderson, straight back in the pocket. He's going to take a shot downfield. Got a man wide open, and the ball is incomplete. DeAndre Bradley came up and laid a lick on number 3, Max Crosby. Crosby looked like he was out early for practice. He was so wide open.
Yeah, the wheel route again causing some trouble for the Horns defense, something that we've kind of seen since that first game of the season against Sox.
I tell you, quarterback Trevor Anderson.
He was looking, look at the replay, he was looking right at the defender. So
Max Crosby knew there was trouble coming. That's going to bring up a third down and 2 from their own 47-yard line. Anderson in the shotgun, Corbin to his left. They hand it off inside to Corbin. Huge hole, 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, 25. And he's finally taken down inside the 15-yard line by DeAndre Bradley. all the way down to the 13, a 40-yard gain by the running back, the senior 200-pounder, number 27, DeMarco Corbin. And the game just full of big plays right now, and Colleyville Heritage has the ball, and they're making it.
And right guard Trey Poirier for Colleyville Heritage, a good job of getting up on the linebacker.
On first down and 10, they hand it off to Corbin again. They're going to hold him to two as he goes over left tackle. He's brought down there by the Longhorns' number 51, Roderick Frazier, the defensive end. 1:52 left in the half. Longhorns lead 22-9. Second down and 8 for Colleyville. They operate from the Cedar Hill 11-yard line. Twin receivers right, one to the left. Quarterback draw. Anderson going to be taken down inside the 10 after a gain of 1. And credit that tackle to 31, Colby McGarry. And that's going to bring up a key third down now for Colleyville Heritage. If Colleyville can punch this in for a touchdown, we may be in for a long dogfight today. Failure to score here could really turn things the Longhorns' way.
Yeah, the Horns really need to get some negative plays and get Colleyville Heritage behind the down and distance.
On third down, direct snap to Anderson, straight back in the pocket. Looking. Throws the out route. Got a man out there. Ball's completed the 8. But quickly, the receiver's thrown down by Eric Sutton. The ball was completed to number 9, Camden Arnold, the wide receiver. But that's going to bring up fourth down. Great play by Sutton.
Eric Sutton did a tremendous job not allowing himself to get picked as the outside receiver ran a slot route and the inside receiver ran a thin out.
With 45 seconds to go in the half, Colleyville Heritage will take a timeout. We'll keep it right here. Longhorns leading 20-9. Longhorns spotted Colleyville Heritage a 9-0 first quarter lead. But since then, Cody, it's been all Cedar Hill. The Longhorns have run off 20 straight points, but tip of the cap to Colleyville Heritage for putting together this drive at the end of the first half.
Yeah, absolutely. They've done a great job of this drive to really get down the field in a hurry. They still have 45 seconds left here. It's going to be really interesting to see when they break the huddle if they're going to have the offense or the special teams unit on. I think if I'm Colleyville Heritage, I may want to put some points up on the board, get to 8 points, and a chance of being within one possession.
Well, as they come back onto the field, it does appear that there will be an attempt at a field goal. Longhorns must watch the fake here. The hole will be by the punter, number 37, Stephen Bodish. Junior Max Allen, number 1, will be trying this field goal. It'll be from the right hash mark, and it'll be a 24-yard field goal attempt. Bodish to hold, Allen to kick. Direct snap will come to the holder. They're trying to get an offside penalty. They don't. The kick is up, and it is lined right through, and it is good with 41 seconds left. Make it 40 as the clock runs an extra tick. 20-12 now is the score. Longhorn football on KBXD and the Champion Sports Radio Network. We'll be back in a moment.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
You're listening to Texas High School Football on KBXD AM 1480, Dallas, the powerhouse of North Texas. Back at AT&T Stadium, the Cedar Hill Longhorns hold Colleyville Heritage to a field goal with 40 seconds to go here in the first half. Longhorns leading 20-12, kicking off for Colleyville Heritage will be number 82, Connor Cole, the sophomore. He approaches the ball, and he hits a long end-over-end kick, and it's going to be Denver Daniels at the 10. Bringing it up to the 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. There's a flag down. This one's coming back. It's not Denver Daniels, but Jalen Jackson that takes it all the way back to the Colleyville 42-yard line. But a flag came down around the 38-yard line, and we'll just have to see if the Longhorns were guilty of a push in the back or a hold. Let's listen to the official call. Looks like Josh Stewart, number 84, got caught with his hand in the cookie jar cam, and that'll be a 10-yard penalty, wiping out a 48-yard return by Jalen Jackson.
Yeah, and you can see it. Stewart kind of took him down. He got his arm around the defender, kind of in a bear hug position, and anytime you do that, whether the guy is going down or not, the ref's going to throw that flag.
It's going to put the ball all the way back to the Cedar Hill 29-yard line, and with 30 seconds, the Longhorns feel like that's plenty of time to score. They keep two backs in the backfield, one receiver wide to the left, twins to the right, McMillan in the shotgun. Now Daniels goes in motion. McMillan on the draw play to Ware to the 40, and he's taken down after about a 10-yard gain. Should be enough for a first down. They'll stop the clock with 23 seconds to go. Longhorns somehow, guys, have one timeout remaining. I don't know how that happened. We got to ask the coaching staff.
Yeah, this is play clock running.
I'm sorry, play clock running. Game clock down to 15. McMillan going to throw it straight back in the pocket. He's letting one go deep downfield. Darius Harper makes a spectacular catch at the 18-yard line. Oh, my goodness gracious. He went up over the defensive back. 5 seconds, and the Longhorns going to take a timeout. Now they're going to save their timeout. Now they're going to take it with 5 seconds left.
I almost wish they would have taken the timeout a little bit quicker. What a play by Darius Harper.
What an unbelievable catch all the way down at the 17-yard line of Cedar Hill. Darius Harper makes a sensational catch. The clock has stopped with 5 seconds left, and the Longhorns now have to decide from the 18 whether or not they're going to try one shot in the end zone, or they're going to let Brooks Ralph come on to try a field goal attempt of what will be 35 yards.
I think they're going to go for a touchdown here. I don't know if they have enough time to get two plays in, especially this distance, but just to go back to that reception, really a great throw. I know it was underthrown, but you teach your quarterback to at least give the receiver an opportunity to make a play, and McMillan did that.
What an unbelievable throw. A 47-yard pass and catch from Justin McMillan, and Darius Harper looked like Alvin Harper from the 1990s going up and over the defensive back for Colleyville Heritage to make a sensational catch. The Longhorns will try a field goal. It'll be from the right hash mark. It'll be a 35-yard attempt from Brooks Ralph. Patience, Brooks. Don't rush it because you got plenty of leg. They'll actually mark it on the 24. Let's make it a 34-yard kick. The snap is good. The kick is on the way. Bingo, bango, bongo. Brooks Ralph from 34 yards is good. And the Cedar Hill Longhorns close out the first half of today's Division II Round 1 6A High School State Playoff game, leading Colleyville Heritage 23-12. When we come back, you'll get to hear what you missed due to technical difficulties before the game. And that was the head coach Joey McGuire's show. You're listening to Cedar Hill Longhorn football on KDXD Dallas 1480, the powerhouse of North Texas, and the Champion Sports Radio Network.
Buford Roofing and Construction is a family-owned company you can trust. Buford Roofing specializes in roofing replacement and repair for the outside of your home or business, and radiant barriers and insulation for the inside. They use top-quality materials, professionally trained crews, and guarantee total customer satisfaction. When you use Buford Roofing and Construction, you can consider yourself protected. They're online at BufordRoofing.com or call 817-329-ROOF.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
Buford Roofing and Construction is a family-owned company you can trust. Buford Roofing specializes in roofing replacement and repair for the outside of your home or business, and radiant barriers and insulation for the inside. They use top quality materials, professionally trained crews, and guarantee total customer satisfaction. When you use Buford Roofing and Construction, you can consider yourself protected. They're online at BufordRoofing.com or call 817-329-ROOF.
Shell experts here with a pitching machine and a shield to demonstrate the importance of protecting your engine.
Think of me as an engine. The shield is new Shell gasoline with 20% more nitrogen and rich cleaning agents than before.
And the baseballs are gunk that attack intake valves and fuel injectors.
Come on, gunk, is that all you got?
Gunk is out of here!
New Shell nitrogen-enriched gasolines. No other gasoline protects your engine better.
For quality auto service and repair, see the folks at Flat Shell on Preston Road at I-635.
Are you tired of only spending time as a family huddled around the TV? Would you like to enjoy some culture with your loved ones without breaking the bank? Then let me introduce you to the Greater Dallas Youth Orchestra. The GDYO provides music education and performance opportunities for musically talented youth, but this is no kids' concert. The GDYO comprises seven different ensembles made up of over 425 talented musicians ages 8 to 18, representing more than 50 communities in North Texas. You won't believe how amazing these ensembles sound until you hear it for yourself. So join them for one of their concerts at the Meyerson Symphony Center or Dallas City Performance Hall. For more information on how to make a donation, as well as a listing of upcoming GDYO concerts, visit gdyo.org. And if you know a talented young musician interested in an unbelievable experience, auditions take place in the spring. Connect with the Greater Dallas Youth Orchestra on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and at gdyo.org.
Do you need a boost in exposure? Want to reach local community-minded folks with information about your business? Join the team and advertise during these games. Advertising during high school broadcasts allows your business to reach thousands of local fans right from your community. We use the latest technology in sports broadcasting so that fans at the game will be able to listen live to the broadcast and the commercials. It's also a way for your business to give back to the community by helping all of these well-deserving student-athletes get some recognition for their accomplishments. The cost simply cannot be beat for the effect it will have. You get a lot of bang for your buck. And best of all, it provides an opportunity for the best advertisement of all, word of mouth. To secure your prime commercial spot during the broadcast, contact Thomas Lee at Champion Sports Radio by phone at 972-741-0334. That's 972-741-0334 or online at championsportsradio.com. Champion Sports Radio, your home for championship broadcasts.
You're listening to the Halftime Show. Cedar Hill leads Colleyville Heritage by a score. Well, Colleyville started out with a quick lead over Cedar Hill, but Cedar Hill able to bounce back. Mech Hike Ford in DeSoto, where you can get the great Mech Hike feeling on I-35 between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads in DeSoto. If you're looking for a contractor to assist you with some roofing repairs, consider Buford Roofing and Construction. When you use Buford Roofing and Construction, you can consider yourself protected and satisfied, as satisfaction is guaranteed. We weren't able to get the Joey McGuire show head coach of the Cedar Hill Longhorns to you during the pregame. So we'll go ahead and get you listening in.
We're here for the playoff of the head coach Joey McGuire show with Cedar Hill football head coach Joey McGuire. And coach, first and foremost, congratulations on the 8-6A district championship and getting ready for today's first-round playoff game with Colleyville Heritage.
Thank you very much. You know, that championship took 10 full games, every single second of 10 full games. And I was really proud of the way our kids, they didn't panic, played their tails off at the end, and did a great job.
Last week, your Longhorns, the game you're referring to, you defeat South Grand Prairie 37-35 on literally the last play of the football game, an 8-yard touchdown pass from Justin McMillan to Josh Stewart. Take us through the last 3 minutes, 4 minutes of that game with your team trailing and the district championship on the line. Coaching staff, players, everyone really seemed to keep their composure right to the very end when you won the game on the last play.
Well, you know, you start with the coaches. My assistant coaches are incredible. You know, and they've been in some huge games over the last few years, so they're not going to panic. You know, they keep their heads and they have a plan. And then the kids have been in some huge games. And, you know, that's one thing I've always said, really whenever we got this tradition going, is you're going to have to beat us. You're not going to sit there and get a team that's going to give up at any point in the game. It's going to be four quarters no matter what the score is. And, you know, I thought our kids did a great job of executing. We got a huge block punt. You know, the play before that, they had a big play, and we had a huge tackle in the secondary by Jamil Moore and Kalen Jackson. And, you know, that was huge to get that because it put them in a situation where are they going to go for it or are they going to punt it? And they punted it, and Richard Moore came up with a huge block.
Well, before we get to our touchdown drive to win the game, talk a little bit about what were the coaching staff and the players prepared for South Grand Prairie to go for that 4th-and-2 from the Cedar Hill 37?
Yeah, we were. We came out and we were going into our, an old, really true 50 defense to where we were in man coverage all the way across. We did actually have Jalen Jackson in the game as a safety. So if they did punt it, then he could move back, to at least try to get it where they're not going to down it inside the 10-yard line. So I thought we had a great plan. They came out of a timeout, and, they decided to punt it. It's a tough situation there. You know, with us, we always go for everything. That's just our brand of football. But you also can understand you punt the football and play defense and make it a long field. You know, and they'd been playing pretty good defense, and we were having a hard time throwing the football at different times. So, you know, it was kind of coach picked to punt the football, and we were lucky enough. You know, we felt like all week long that we were going to block a punt and we were going to block a field goal, and we did both of them.
Well, that turned out to be the block punt portion, turned out to be absolutely be the biggest play of the game, but still what had to happen after that was your offense had to execute, had to drive down the field a minute.
The play before that, they had a big play, and we had a huge tackle in the secondary by Jamil Moore and Kalen Jackson. And, that was huge to get that because it put them in a situation where are they going to go for it or are they going to punt it? And they punted it, and Richard Moore came up with a huge block.
Well, before we get to our touchdown drive to win the game, talk a little bit about what were the coaching staff and the players prepared for South Grand Prairie to go for that 4th-and-2 from the Cedar Hill 37?
Yeah, we were. We came out and we were going into our, an old, really true 50 defense to where we were in man coverage all the way across. We did actually have Jalen Jackson in the game as a safety. So if they did punt it, then he could move back, to at least try to get it where they're not going to down it inside the 10-yard line. So I thought we had a great plan. They came out of a timeout, and, they decided to punt it. It's a tough situation there. You know, with us, we always go for everything. That's just our brand of football. But you also can understand you punt the football and play defense and make it a long field, you know, and they'd been playing pretty good defense, and we were having a hard time throwing the football at different times. So, you know, it's kind of coach picked to punt the football, and we were lucky enough. You know, we felt like all week long that we were going to block a punt and we were going to block a field goal, and we did both of them.
Well, that turned out to be the block punt portion, turned out to be absolutely be the biggest play of the game, but still what had to happen after that was your offense had to execute, had to drive down the field, a minute 50 left and one timeout, and Justin McMillan, who had an up-and-down night, really came through there at the end and was just simply outstanding in that final drive.
No, he was. He did an incredible job. I mean, you're talking about a state champion quarterback, kid that's going to LSU and has just an incredible sense about him of winning and going to play football and doing what you have to do to win a football game. And man, he did an incredible job of every single snap, composure, stepping up in the pocket. I thought that Coach Oubre and Coach Woods, you know, had a great plan. We moved Justice Powers out to tackle, so that gave us a better pocket to throw in.
And was Powers moved out to tackle one of the few times that night that he had played that position?
Yeah, that was the last time he played tackle was when we beat Lake Travis.
Oh, well, there you go. It was a long time ago. Of course, the play that set everything up, Longhorns have a 3rd and 2, and Justin trying to make something happen, gets sacked for a 12-yard loss, sets up a 4th and 14, the season on the line. What a great throw on a comeback sideline route to DeMarcus Lodge. Talk about the execution of that play.
Nah, just an incredible throw. I mean, you know, and everybody knows where we're going. The good thing probably was that it was that kind of distance, so they were going to play off to the sticks. So Lodge was able to push past the sticks, and then, you know, there's a reason we call him the whip. I mean, he's got the livest arm in the state of Texas, if not the nation, and, man, he threw it out there, and those two dudes have connected on a lot of big plays, and that was a huge play that they connected on.
Just a couple of plays later in the drive with no timeouts remaining, the offensive coordinator Michael Glaze opts to call a running play inside to Denver Daniels with no timeouts. Daniels for a moment looked like he may score, and then he was tripped up and the Longhorns had to get to the line quickly and spike the ball.
Yeah, yeah, it was one of those deals, you know, try to get a quick, maybe we could pop one. You know, they were thinking pass. Probably should have done it on that 3rd and 2. But we came back, ran it, and, you know, he got tripped up. He's right there to score. There was about 3 plays in that series to where Denver Daniels is going to score. You know, if we'd have gone to him once,
tackles, right?
We had the run, and then, you know, just kind of a pass that kind of got thrown. If he would have caught that pass, you know, we're probably on the 2 or we're scoring.
Correct. So that, of course, sets up the second to the last play of the game, which turned out to be a fairly important play, trying to hit Josh Stewart on a crossing around the back of the end zone. It was incomplete, and I can only assume that if the Longhorns go on to win a state championship, there will have to be a state championship ring in the future of the Gopher Bowl clock operator that left us with 1 second to play.
Well, you know, there's no doubt, man. That's one of the things that's really tough. You know, I applaud him from the standpoint of doing his job.
Absolutely.
I mean, because he could have easily, if you sit there and you watch it on film and you time it out, then there should have been a second left on the clock.
Yes.
Whenever that, you know, when that ball hit the ground, so there was a second left. It was awesome that we were able to come back to Josh. We throw slant, it hits him in the hands, he doesn't make the catch, and then we come back the next play and, you know, kind of a backyard scramble drill, and he's sitting in the end zone and catches a great ball.
Well, on that last play of the game, that's exactly what it was, Coach. Justin McMillan got in a little bit of trouble. He looked, and finally at the front pylon finds Josh Stewart. And Josh hadn't had a lot of catches this year, but he's been one of the best punters in the state of Texas. But that had to be the biggest play of the year for him.
Oh, no doubt. Huge, huge play. And, you know, he's a kid that he reminds me a lot of Quincy Adebojo from the standpoint of you think back of Quincy as a junior and not having a lot of catches. I mean, Josh probably got as many as Quincy did as a junior. And, you know, just through rep, and becoming better and catching more balls, Josh Stewart, I mean, because he's definitely got the size and the athletic ability, he's going to be a great receiver for us in the future.
Well, that took the 8-6A championship game, championship under our belts with that final play, and that means that today's game would not be against South Lake Carroll, but would be instead against Colleyville Heritage, and we'll talk about Colleyville Heritage when we come back to the Head Coach Joey McGuire Show.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
Stay up on all the latest news about the teams you care about and know when your favorite games are on the air thanks to Champion Sports Radio social media. Either follow at Champion Sports on Twitter or like our Facebook page at facebook.com/Champion Sports Radio, and you will know what time your game starts, who was named Player of the Week, or what your school's alumni are doing in college. That's on Twitter at Champion Sports and facebook.com/Champion Sports Radio. Your home for championship social media.
Many heart conditions can be fixed, but many of us don't know we have a problem until it's too late. On April 2, 2009, Zachary Schraw, a 16-year-old sophomore offensive lineman, died of sudden cardiac arrest, the number one cause of death among student athletes. Like so many SCA victims, Zach had no heart issues, nor did anyone in his family. If Zach had an echocardiogram, he might have been able to avoid suffering a condition that takes 10,000 of our youth each year. In his memory, Living for Zachary was formed to try and prevent SCA from taking the lives of youth everywhere. Join in the fight today and stop the silent killer of SCA by scheduling your young athlete for an echocardiogram, a procedure that can detect any heart issue with 99% accuracy. For more information, visit www.livingforzachary.org. That's living, the number 4, Zachary.org, and let your heart be heard.
There's a time and a place for everything.
As you'll see, projections for the next quarter are...
He shoots, he scores! 2 points for team middle management.
The office is not one of them.
Jack, can I see you in my office?
No pouting, it's your ball, let's see what you got.
But Whirly Ball is.
For corporate events, team building, and private parties, Whirly Ball in Hearst and Plano is electric fun. Test your skills on the arcade games. Zip around in your Whirly Bug for a Whirly Ball competition. Or play the most affordable laser tag in the city. Learn more at whirlyball.info.
In Command Broadcasting, a sports TV broadcasting and marketing company. In Command Broadcasting provides a wide array of turnkey video production and streaming services. In Command services include filming of sporting events, season highlights, school graduations, corporate infomercials, and documentaries. In Command streams your sporting event or company function over the internet live or on demand. Call 972-851-7888 to raise the energy of your next event. In Command Broadcasting, 972-851-7888.
Writer Gerald Early said that when they study our civilization 2,000 years from now, there will only be three things that Americans will be known for: the Constitution, baseball, and jazz music. GDYO's Jazz Institute provides young musicians in North Texas the opportunity to learn what it means to be a jazz musician through weekly technique classes and combo rehearsals with professional jazz musicians. From the first note to the final round of applause, GDYO Jazz Institute concerts will amaze and delight both hardcore jazz cats and new fans alike. Learn more about the truly original American art form through the GDYO Jazz Institute online at gdyo.org/jazz.
Yeah, Colleyville Heritage has done a pretty good job of keeping things close, and statistically, the numbers kind of bear it out as we've seen Colleyville Heritage not be just really dominated yardage-wise. Cedar Hill has 312 total yards, and to Colleyville Heritage 164, while Cedar Hill has just about tripled them up with 13 first downs, while Colleyville Heritage only has been able to garner 5. Yeah, for some reason, really, Colleyville Heritage came out with a great scheme, and they were really able to kind of get up on Cedar Hill as they scored 9 quick points, and the Longhorns were able to get things together toward the end of the first half.
Sorry about that. Is that a little bit better? All right. Going to have to learn to work this doggone equipment someday. Back at AT&T Stadium here with about 2.5 minutes to go before the start of the second half, the Cedar Hill Longhorns leading Colleyville Heritage 23-12. And the Longhorns, Cam, is your statistics that you were just going over. You know, it bears out that the Longhorn offense got started slowly, but after that, in the second quarter, it's been all Cedar Hill.
Yeah, Justin McMillan has 69 yards passing as he's 4 of 6 with no touchdowns and a pick. But he did have the huge play at the end of the half to Darius Harper. Denver Daniels and McMillan have really led the Longhorn rushing attack, though, as they're both averaging over 15 yards per carry. Denver Daniels has 113 yards already, averaging 16 yards per attempt with a touchdown. And McMillan has a 18 yards per carry with a touchdown.
Well, and I tell you, those averages are really ballooned by the fact that they both had huge touchdown runs. Denver Daniels with a 76-yard touchdown run to get the Longhorn scoring started. And then Justin McMillan with a 45-yard touchdown run to give the Longhorns their first lead of the game.
Yeah, and again, you're listening to Longhorn football on KBXD and Champion Sports Radio. KBXD, Dallas, the power of North Texas. Cedar Hill leads 23-12 as we approach the start of the second half. We'll be back after a message and a few words from our sponsor.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
Buford Roofing and Construction is a family-owned company you can trust. Buford Roofing specializes in roofing replacement and repair for the outside of your home or business and radiant barriers and insulation for the inside. They use top-quality materials, professionally trained crews, and guarantee total customer satisfaction. When you use Buford Roofing and Construction, you can consider yourself protected. They're online at BufordRoofing.com or call 817-329-ROOF.
Shell Experts here to talk about the protective shield you see at Shell stations all over the country.
Featuring us.
It's there to remind you that no other gasoline protects your engine better than Shell nitrogen-enriched gasoline. Mm-hmm. Now with 20% more cleaning agents than before.
Performance-robbing gunk doesn't stand a chance because your intake valves and fuel injectors are protected.
Actively shielded.
Hence the big protective shield here.
So try Shell nitrogen-enriched gasolines today. No other gasoline protects your engine better.
For quality auto service and repair, see the folks at Flat Shell on Preston Road at I-635.
Are you tired of only spending time as a family huddled around the TV? Would you like to enjoy some culture with your loved ones without breaking the bank? Then let me introduce you to the Greater Dallas Youth Orchestra. The GDYO provides music education and performance opportunities for musically talented youth, but this is no kids' concert. The GDYO comprises 7 different ensembles made up of over 425 talented musicians ages 8 to 18, representing more than 50 communities in North Texas. You won't believe how amazing these ensembles sound until you hear it for yourself. So join them for one of their concerts at the Meyerson Symphony Center or Dallas City Performance Hall. For more information on how to make a donation, as well as a listing of upcoming GDYO concerts, visit gdyo.org. And if you know a talented young musician interested in an unbelievable experience, auditions take place in the spring. Connect with the Greater Dallas Youth Orchestra on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and at gdyo.org.
Point of Origin Design is your one-stop shop for all your apparel, promotional, event, or team uniform needs. Point of Origin Design is a full-service design and logo creation company that offers a wide variety of imprintable and embroidered products. With competitive pricing and quality work, you can't go wrong with Point of Origin Design. It's always best to start at the right point, so visit them online at pointoforigindesign.com. Let them help you plan your next promotional item or design your next t-shirt. That's online at pointoforigindesign.com.
Stay up on all the latest news about the teams you care about and know when your favorite games are on the air thanks to Champion Sports Radio social media. Either follow at Champion Sports on Twitter or like our Facebook page at facebook.com/Champion Sports Radio, and you will know what time your game starts, who was named Player of the Week, or what your school's alumni are doing in college. That's on Twitter at Champion Sports and facebook.com/Champion Sports Radio, your home for championship social media.
Back at AT&T Stadium, we're set for the second half of action between Cedar Hill and Colleyville Heritage. Your Longhorns leading Colleyville Heritage 23-12, and Cedar Hill will receive the second half kickoff. I'm Bill Howard, along with my broadcast partners Cam Boland and Cody Trim, our spotter for today's game, Trevor Williams. And our first half was a little bit of everything, but Cedar Hill got the better end of the deal. Colleyville Heritage set to kick off, and a long end-over-end kick is going to be taken by Denver Daniels at the 3, up to the 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and he's across the 30 and down to the 33-yard line. In fact, they'll mark him down about the 34, so a 31-yard return for Daniels to start the second half.
Yeah, very good blocking, and it started with kind of his fellow return guys and Jalen Jackson and DeAndre Bradley, allowing him to have a little bit of breeze and gained it.
First down and 10, Longhorns. They start from their own 34-yard line to begin the third period. Longhorns lead 23-12. McMillan in the shotgun, backs on either side, and Kobe Edomwanye, I believe it was, might have flinched a little early. It was. The tight end, Edomwanye, flinches, and it's a 5-yard penalty for Cedar Hill. And the first drive of the third quarter starting a little bit like the game started for Cedar Hill's offense. A little uneven, but eventually the Longhorns got it here. First and 15, now back to the 29. McMillan in the shotgun, Daniels to his left, Ware to his right, twin receivers to the right. Motion by Daniels from left to right. They throw it out to Denver on the bubble screen to the 30, and he gets up to the 35 and will be taken down right at the 35-yard line. As McMillan sent Daniels in motion to the right, then stood up and threw the bubble screen to the right, to him, ends up picking up the 5 yards and an extra yard that was lost.
And Cam went over some stats there at the first half. One stat that kind of stands out to me, Lodge, no yardage on the ground, no yardage through the air. Let's see if they can get him involved here in the second half.
Ware to the left, Daniels to the right of McMillan. They hand it off to McMillan and gives it to Lodge on the reverse, coming back to the 35 and up to the 38. A 3-yard gain. Lodge fumbles the ball, but not until he was already down. And the first plus yardage of the day for DeMarcus Lodge. A 3-yard gain on the reverse to lead the Longhorns with a third down and about 7 to go for the first down. Colleyville Heritage has done an excellent job of taking away Haka Cedric Ware and DeMarcus Lodge so far today. On third down and 7, McMillan in the shotgun, hands off inside to Haka Cedric Ware, and Ware's going to get all the way up to the 43-yard line. He is going to be just short of the first down, and here we are on fourth down again, and the Longhorns are going to go again. Haka Cedric Ware is in the Wildcat as the quarterback on fourth down and 2. Direct snap to Ware. He waits. Now hits to the outside. He's got to the 45, up to the 50, and down to the 48-yard line. Cam, the Longhorns obviously saw something on field that allows them to take advantage in real short yardage situations of Colleyville's defensive scheme.
Yeah, and it really looks like they want to go quicker on the snap. Christian didn't want to take his time, and you would want to have the offensive line comfortable with the ball.
That first down brought to you by Mack Hike Ford in DeSoto. Longhorns now in Colleyville territory at the Colleyville 49, first down and 10. Direct snap to McMillan, inside hand off to Aka Cedric. He pounds up the middle across the 46, down close to the 45. Let's give him 3 yards on the play, make it second and 7.
And the Longhorns really look like they're going to ground and pound against this Colleyville defense, really moving the ball heavy in the second half.
Full house backfield.
Elijah Moore to the right of McMillan. Akasevic Ware to the left. Denver Daniels, the eye back. Hodge wide to the left, the sole receiver. Direct snap to McMillan. He hands it off inside to Lodge. No, I'm sorry, to Denver Daniels. And Daniels is going to be taken down for no gain. And that's going to bring up third and seven.
Colleyville Heritage really being aggressive and bringing run blitzes as they pretty much shot every gap that time.
It's going to bring up third down at seven. Longmore's going to go trips to the left, twins to the right. Empty backfield set for McMillan. Third and seven from the 47 of Colleyville Heritage. McMillan looks over the defense, takes the direct snap. Throws it to the outside to Lodge. He's got it at the 45, up to the 40, down to the 35. And he's finally taken down all the way down at the 32-yard line. That's a 16-yard gain on the bubble screen from Justin McMillan to DeMarcus Lodge.
And Lodge, with his second reception of the game, he had one catch in the first half at 25 yards. And a good job getting a lot of yak on that.
DeMarcus has got to put the ball away, holding it out freely in one hand makes me very nervous. Twins to the left, H-back Elijah Moore to the right. Ware, inside handoff. Colleyville's going to take him down after just a two-yard gain up to the 31-yard line, make it second down and eight. 8:07 to go here in the third quarter. Longhorns lead 23-12. Longhorns will send wide receivers to either side on second down and eight. McMillan with Ware as the eye back. Direct snap, straight back in the pocket goes McMillan. He's letting it go deep. Got a man down there. Ball's caught. Touchdown, Cedar Hill Longhorns. DeMarcus Lodge. A 33-yard touchdown. And that will give the Cedar Hill Longhorns a 29-12 lead.
And appropriate that Lodge was able to catch a pass like that one here in Cowboy Stadium, as he was kind of reminiscent of one of the previous 88s, as he gave a little bit of a share to the DB.
Longhorns extra point attempt is up and good with 7:39 to go in the third. Longhorns 30, Heritage 12. Longhorns football will be back in a moment.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
Back at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, a 33-yard touchdown pass from Justin McMillan to DeMarcus Lodge, as Lodge went up and over defensive back Bryce Boyd and hauled in the touchdown reception that gives the Longhorns a 30-12 lead after Brooks Ralph converts the extra point. That deep for Colleyville Heritage, Ryan Felipe, number 10, a high end-over-end kick. It's going to be taken by Felipe at the 5, up to the 10, the 15. He's taken down short of the 20-yard line. They'll put him down at about the 17-yard line. And it's number 26, Dimitri Moore, in on the tackle for the Longhorns. An injured player down on the field is number 10, Ryan Felipe. He'll take a break as well. 7:34 to go in the third. Longhorns 30, Heritage 12. Longhorns football on KBXD Dallas. We'll be back in a moment.
Buford Roofing and Construction is a family-owned company you can trust. Buford Roofing specializes in roofing replacement and repair for the outside of your home or business, and radiant barriers and insulation for the inside. They use top quality materials, professionally trained crews, and guarantee total customer satisfaction. When you use Buford Roofing and Construction, you can consider yourself protected. They're online at bufordroofing.com or call 817-329-ROOF.
football on KBXD Dallas, the powerhouse of North Texas, back in Arlington, Texas at AT&T Stadium. The return man for Colleyville Heritage, number 10, Ryan Felipe, is assisted off the field and walks off under his own power now as he gets closer to the sideline. It'll be first down and 10 from the 16-yard line. Let's make it the 17 for Colleyville Heritage. Trevor Anderson, the quarterback, hands it off on first down inside to DeMarco Corbin. Corbin's going to be taken down back at the 15 by a host of Longhorns for a 2-yard loss. We start at the number 98, Big Clinton Coffee. The big defensive tackle got great penetration.
Yeah, Coffee doing a tremendous job. He didn't make the tackle by himself, but he made the play float to the outside, which is not where it was designed to go.
Tim Hutchins, number 45, the first man in for the Longhorns. Second down and 12, Anderson straight back in the pocket. Looking, he's throwing the ball across the middle. Got a man, nice catch up at the 19-yard line by number 4, Nelson Bohannon, the junior wide receiver for Colleyville Heritage. That's going to pick up about 5, and it's going to leave third down. And still about 7-8 yards to go for a first down.
And Richard Moore applied a lot of pressure on the young quarterback, forced him to throw the ball outside.
Anderson alone in the shotgun for Heritage on 3rd and 9. He's straight back in the pocket, throwing the deep in route. The ball's incomplete. It's intended up there for number 85, Nico Torres. But Torres can't come up with the catch. Longhorns with good coverage, and it's fourth down for Heritage. They will punt.
Yeah, tremendous coverage there by number 5, Charlie Middleton, who is still getting his feet back under him after being injured and out for a little bit. Great coverage there downfield and forcing this three and out by Colleyville.
That'll be number 37, Stephen Bodish, on to do the kicking. DeAndre Bradley and DeMarcus Lodge wait around midfield. Bodish's kick is a beauty, a high spiraling kick that's going to take a good Cedar Hill bounce and go out of bounds up around the midfield stripe. In fact, they're going to mark it at the Cedar Hill 49-yard line. So the Longhorns will start their second possession of the second half, leading 30-12 over Colleyville Heritage in great field position at their own 49. Longhorns started very auspiciously today, falling behind 9-0. But since that time, the Longhorn offensive machine has been rolling. They've scored 30 points to Heritage's 3 since the first quarter. Full house backfield from McMillan on 1st and 10 from the 49. They hand it off inside to Ware. Coming right, he's going to turn the corner at the midfield stripe, get up to the 45, turns the corner to the 40, all the way down to the 35-yard line. And Aka Cedric Ware and DeMarcus Lodge have been stopped for the majority of the day. But you can't stop players like that all the time, Ken. That's a 17-yard gain for Aka Cedric.
Yeah, and another good job by the Cedar Hill offensive line and receivers, making sure that the ball carriers are able to gain the edge as Garrett Williams at right tackle pre-seal the edge.
From the 35 of Colleyville, direct snap. Straight back in the pocket goes Lodge. He's looking, he's throwing it deep downfield. He's got a man, and he just misses it. Darris Harper on a deep post route. And McMillan, if he puts a little air under that ball, it may be a touchdown. He threw it pretty hard on the line, I should say. And it's overthrown, and the Longhorns miss a chance to get a score there. But it's second down and 10 with 5:41 to go here in the third quarter. And Cedar Hill leading 30-12. On 2nd and 10 from the 35 of Heritage, the Longhorns go 20 receivers to the right. Ware, the sole set back behind McMillan, he takes the inside handoff. Now they fake it, they throw it out to Lodge on the bubble screen to the 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. And he's going to go out of bounds at the 2-yard line. Oh, what a great play fake to start things. And then DeMarcus Lodge, from there, he takes it from the 35 of Cedar Hill, of Heritage, all the way down to the 2-yard line, a 33-yard gain.
And we hadn't seen a bunch of the play action game on screen passes, but we've seen 2 new plays as we have Ware in the shotgun.
Ware is in the Wildcat on 1st and goal from the 2. Ware takes it up over the right tackle and into the end zone for a touchdown. It increases Cedar Hill's lead to 36-12 with 5:23 to go here in the third period, and the Longhorns starting to make a statement.
Cedar Hill again
line. Wesley Lewis at left guard. Randy Christian at left tackle. Chris Frazier at center. Opening a gaping hole.
Brooks Brown sets the point. He is paying with the 5:23 to go in the third. The Cedar Hill Longhorns have extended their lead to 37-12 over Colleyville Heritage. The Cedar Hill Longhorns won by KPXD Dallas and the championship respect on the network.
There's a time and a place for everything.
As you'll see, projections for the next quarter are...
He shoots, he scores! 2 points for team middle management.
The office is not one of them.
Jack, can I see you in my office?
No pouting, it's your ball, let's see what you got.
But Whirly Ball is. For corporate events, team building, and private parties, Whirly Ball in Hearst and Plano is electric fun. Test your skills on the arcade games. Zip around in your Whirly Bug for a Whirly Ball competition. Or play the most affordable laser tag in the city. Learn more at whirlyball.info.
Back at AT&T Stadium on the Champion Sports Radio Network, KBXT Dallas, the powerhouse of North Texas. I'm Bill Howard, along with my broadcast partners, Cam Bowman and Cody Clem. Since the first quarter at Cedar Hill was outscored 9-0 by Colleyville Heritage, the Longhorn machine has taken over. They have outscored Colleyville Heritage since that point, 37-3, and they have taken a commanding 37-12 lead. Rich Rouse sets a kick off from left to right for the Longhorns. He hits a high end-over-end kick that's going to be fielded by Colleyville Heritage in the 5, and the return man's up to the 15, 20, 25, 30, and he all the way up to the 37-yard line goes number 10, Ryan Felipe. And Felipe, who was injured on the last kickoff, Cam, seems to have made a quick recovery in the 32-yard return of Brooks Rouse's kick.
Yeah, and Felipe can thank his teammates for opening up a really good, nice hole for him there on the return, as he didn't have to make any cuts. But a good job of Cedar Hill eventually getting it down. He was able to cross the
ball. 37-12, Cedar Hill with 5:15 to go in the third quarter. Anderson sends trips to the left. He hands it off inside to DeMarco Kerman. Kerman turns to Kerman with a 45-50 across midfield all the way down to the 46-yard line. And Cedar Hill, a 17-yard gain for running back DeMarco Kerman, the 6'2" senior, who is a good-looking running back.
Yeah, Corbin, really a well-built kid, good speed and acceleration, nice vision, and most importantly, always falls.
On first and 10 from the 47, trips to the right, they run the sweep to the right. They group with number 14, Jamari Williams, and he's going to be stopped for a loss of 3 yards as the Longhorn defense. Excellent penetration again. Kyle Goss, number 22, Kevin Later, number 30, in for the tackle, which sets up Colleyville Heritage with a second down and about 11. They go trips to the left. Straight back in the pocket goes the quarterback Anderson. He's throwing the ball deep downfield. Got a man wide open at the 25, and he overthrows it. Oh, my goodness. Number 17, Trey Arnold, the senior wide receiver, had broken open down the left sideline. But Anderson, under a little bit of pressure, let it go quickly, Cam, and overthrew it.
Yeah, it looked like Darryl Miller had the deep third that time and lost track of his receiver. Luckily, the ball was overthrown out of bounds.
From the 46, it's going to be third down and 11 for Colleyville Heritage. The Cedar Hill 46-yard line, they move from right to left. Anderson in the shotgun. Inside handoff to the first back through is Corbin, and DeMarco is taken down at the 45 after a gain of one, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Actually, they're going to give him a gain of about 2.5 after his forward progress was finally marked down. So it'll be fourth down and 9, and it looks like Colleyville Heritage down 37-12 with 3:53 to go in the third quarter, and the clock running. They're going to go for it here from the Cedar Hill 44-yard line. Third down and 12. Anderson in the shotgun, Corbin to his right. Anderson straight back in the pocket. Here comes the rush. Longhorns got him under pressure. Corbin pulls it down, going to try to run. Going to get the first down. Picked up a great block downfield. They're going to mark it very, very close to the first down marker. We'll just have to see where it is, and it is enough for a first down. Great block picked up downfield. Can't see who it was that threw
it. It was one of the Colleyville Heritage wide receivers, but it took a Cedar Hill defender out of the play, and it's a first down for Colleyville.
Yeah, and that's a huge pickup for Colleyville. If they don't get that, they're giving the ball right back to the potent Cedar Hill offense in good field position.
On first down from the 34, handoff over the right side goes to number 22, Justin Toberny. And Toberny is going to be taken down for no gain. He's going to make it second down and 10. Heritage goes twins to the right and one to the left. Backs on either side of Anderson, who will throw. Straight back in the pocket. He's throwing the ball across the middle. Got a man at the 35. Down to the 30, down to the 29-yard line goes number 9, Camden Arnold, the senior wide receiver. It's going to be a pickup of 7 and leave a third down and 3 for Colleyville Heritage. We play with 2:47 and the clock running in the third quarter from AT&T Stadium, Cedar Hill 37, Colleyville Heritage 12. Anderson in the shotgun, tries to run the quarterback draw, and he's taken down back at the 32-yard line. Holy moly! Number 53, Jalen Pitt, came unblocked and was able to take Anderson down for what's going to end up being about a 5-yard loss.
And I think that's one of those plays where the D-tackle comes unblocked by design, and they try to fool him and make him commit to the running back, and it's up to the quarterback to make the read. That time, Penn did just a tremendous job not allowing the ball carrier to get anywhere.
That's going to make it fourth down now, and about 5 to go, maybe 6 to go for the first down. Anderson in the shotgun on 4th and 6, he'll throw. Straight back in the pocket, throwing the out route. Got a man, but the ball's caught at the 29-yard line. And number 2 for the Longhorns, DeMarcy Perry, tackles him immediately. And Colleyville Heritage got away with a pick play there against Eric Sutton, but DeMarcy Perry didn't care. He came up and made the stop anyway.
And that's what you call teamwork. DeMarcy Perry switched out, saw that Sutton was picked by the inside receiver, and still made the tackle, so there was no gain. Or additional yardage gained by the ball carrier.
So the ball will go over on downs to the Cedar Hill Longhorns with 1:51 to go in the third, and the Longhorns leading 37-12. Denver Daniels will be the running back. The Longhorns got it first and 10 from their own 27. McMillan in the shotgun, Daniels behind it. Wide receivers to either side of the field. Inside handoff to Daniels. He gets to the 30, 35. Breaks one tackle, gets to the 40. Still running hard to the 42, 3. They'll mark it down about the 44-yard line.
And I got to tell you, Bill, since Daniels came back from the shoulder arm injury, he's been, it almost seems like a different ball player. He's running like a man possessed.
Well, I know that after the DeSoto game, he felt strongly that his season may be over. So did the doctors. It turned out the arm wasn't broken. He was able to come back, and I think he really is appreciating that second chance that he's getting. 17 yards on that carry up near the 44-yard line. Longhorns first and 10, 1:33 to go in the third. Longhorns lead 37-12. Backs on either side of the pillar. Aka Cedar Ware to the right, Elijah Moore to the left. Twins to the right, one to the left. Inside handoff to Moore to the 45, to the 50. Give him about 7 yards. Elijah Moore doesn't get to carry the rock off and pretty excited he gets a chance, Cody.
Yeah, absolutely. Hit that hole hard, hit the gap, kept his legs turning all the way up to the 50-yard line there, right at midfield. Great run there by Moore to pick up 8.
Second down and 3, packs on either side of the building. Inside handoff to Aka Cedar. He's going to be taken down to the backfield, but he gets away. He stays on his feet. Now he's going to be taken down all the way back at the for a loss of 6 as a full-out run blitz can by Colleyville Heritage was that duped that play from the start.
Yeah, and it's really a boom or a bust, a kind of a risk that you're taking when you're doing all those run blitzes. Aka Cedar Warren's got caught in the backfield a couple times with the perimeter runs. Denver Daniels has gained some hit.
Third down and 9, McMillan in the shotgun, twins left and right. Draw play, inside handoff to Ware. He's going to be taken down again in the backfield. He tries to stay on his feet, but he's only going to pick up about a half yard on what will be the final play of the third period. When we return, Cedar Hill will be looking at a punting situation as the third quarter comes to a close. The Cedar Hill Longhorns, 37, Colleyville Heritage, 12. Cedar Hill Longhorns football, 1380, the powerhouse of Texas. We'll be back in a moment.
Point of Origin Design is your one-stop shop for all your apparel, promotional, event, or team uniform needs. Point of Origin Design is a full-service design and logo creation company that offers a wide variety of imprintable and embroidered products. With competitive pricing and quality work, you can't go wrong with Point of Origin Design. It's always best to start at the right point, so visit them online at pointoforigindesign.com. Let them help you plan your next promotional item or design your next t-shirt. That's online at pointoforigindesign.com.
Back at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, we begin the fourth period of play of this Texas 6A Division II Round 1 playoff game. The Cedar Hill Longhorns dominated Colleyville Heritage today, 37-12. And the Longhorn punter, Josh Stewart, stands in his own 30-yard line, back deep. For Colleyville Heritage, number 10, Ryan Felipe. The snap is a good one back to Stewart. And Stewart hits a line drive punt. It drives Felipe back to the 10-yard line. Inside the 5, the Longhorns bring him down. Oh, my goodness. Number 26, Moore, comes down and makes a sensational tackle. They're going to give Felipe forward progress to the 8-yard line. But I tell you, great kick by Josh Stewart. Great coverage by Cedar Hill.
And Bill, number 26, Jamil Moore, has been around the ball on special teams all game today, has made a ton of plays.
Jamil Moore, number 26, has had a whale of a game on special teams. Jamil Moore is a guy that is...
I think he may be a guy that they brought up from JV for playoffs, and he has definitely made a difference on the special team unit.
First down and 10 for Colleyville Heritage from the 8-yard line. One back behind Anderson. Play action pass. Anderson rolls out, throwing the ball deep downfield. Got a man, overthrows number 7.
And it looks like Carter. It looks like they're going to have a flag for roughing the passer.
Finally covered their wheel route. Great job by DeMarcy Perry of covering their wheel route, but it looks like...
Penalty on number 54 for the Longhorns. Quentin Jones, who's coming hard on the pressure. As we look at the replay right now, he did take an extra couple of steps there. It's a good call by the officials. The 15-yard penalty will move the ball out to the 23 of Colleyville Heritage with 11:41 to go in the game, and Cedar Hill leading 37-12. Twins to the right, ball on the right hash mark. DeMarco Corbin in the backfield. Play action pass, rolling out to the right is Anderson, going across the field. Got a man, intended for number 6, but incomplete. And number 8, rather, I'm sorry, Jackson Celadon was the intended receiver. And the ball went through his hands. Looked like a pretty good throw by number 6, Trevor Anderson, on that one.
Yeah, and again, the Longhorns having a little bit of trouble with the underneath routes. The receivers are finding some openings.
Second down and 10 from the right hash mark. Twins to the right, one to the left. Inside handoff to DeMarco Corbin. He gets across the 25 up to the 30 and is marked just outside the 30-yard line. An 8-yard gain for DeMarco Corbin.
And you can see why Northern Illinois would be interested in a kid like DeMarco Corbin, as that's where he's headed already, as he's provided him with his verbal commitment. And he's doing a good job of finding open lanes.
On first down and 10, they give it to Corbin again. This time the Longhorn defense ready for him as Corbin goes over the right tackle. And Richard Moore, number 4, the first Longhorn to meet in there, the All-Stater and high school All-American Richard Moore, having a whale of a game.
And I believe that's going to bring up another fourth down here.
It will. It'll bring up fourth down and about 2 yards to go. Maybe a yard to go now that they spotted the ball down at the 32-yard line. Colleyville Heritage now will go for it. But before they do, they're going to take a timeout, and so will we. 10:39 to go here at AT&T Stadium. Cedar Hill 37, Colleyville Heritage 12, on one football back.
Stay up on all the latest news about the teams you care about and know when your favorite games are on the air thanks to Champion Sports Radio social media. Either follow @ Champion Sports on Twitter or like our Facebook page at facebook.com BiDistrict.com/championsportsradio, and you will know what time your game starts, who was named Player of the Week, or what your school's alumni are doing in college. That's on Twitter at championsports and Facebook.com/championsportsradio, your home for championship social media.
Back at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, Bill Howard along with Cam Bowen, Cody Crib, and Trevor Williams as we watch the Cedar Hill Longhorns making their way through their first-round opponent, Colleyville Heritage, with 10:39 to go here in the fourth. The Longhorns leading 37-12. The Longhorns look to be headed to a second-round matchup with McKinney Boyd. That'll be next week at 2 p.m. here at AT&T Stadium. Please join us again, KBXD and Champion Sports Radio. On fourth down and two, the direct snap goes to DeMarco Corbin, and he goes down the right sideline to the 40, 45, 50. Cuts back to the inside of the middle, 40, 35, all the way down to the Cedar Hill 29-yard line. A 39-yard run. But there's a flag down way back upfield, and this one may be coming back.
Yeah.
Well, personal foul against Cedar Hill. Not real sure what could have caused the personal foul during the course of the play, but I didn't see it. And as a result, let's let that 39-yard run stand for the Wildcat running back that time, number 27, DeMarco Corbin, who's having a heck of a day.
Yeah, he has a nearly 150 yards rushing on the night so far with the touchdown.
So that's going to give a first down at the 15-yard line after the penalty of 15 yards is tacked on. Anderson in the shotgun. He'll throw on first down. Looking into the end zone, throws right corner. Got a man ball dropped in the right corner of the end zone. Number 9, Camden Arnold, had his hands on it but couldn't bring it in. Trevor Anderson been the victim of a couple of drops today, Cam. He's thrown some very good football.
Yeah, and it looked like the football was overthrown initially, but it actually was a perfect pass right over the outstretched arms of the receiver, and the defender had no chance at making the play.
On second down, inside handoff to number 27, DeMarco Corbin, and he's going to take it right up the pipe and walk in for a touchdown.
Yeah, the counterplay. This great job backside blocking by the offensive line. The big difference, the linebacker.
DeMarco Corbin goes 15 yards. That'll put him over the 160-yard mark for the day and make it a 37-18 game. And Colleyville Heritage with 10:07 to go. We'll go for two. Trevor Anderson in the shotgun. He'll throw on the two-point conversion, throws the out route, the ball's incomplete, but Cedar Hill's going to be guilty of pass interference. Going to be 22. Kyle Goss had his hands on the receiver while the ball's in the air, or possibly number 5.
It looked like Charlie Middleton there came off his receiver as he saw a man coming wide open. It was Corbin wide open into the flat and hit him a little earlier.
37-18, and another attempt at the two-point conversion forthcoming for Colleyville Heritage. They were running the flat route outside. It was number 5. You're absolutely right, Cody. Charlie Middleton got there a little bit early.
And Middleton really had an opportunity to catch an interception, but he wasn't able to get his hand around.
So the two-point conversion will be reattempted. This time it will be from inside the 2-yard line. We'll make it at about the 1. 37-18, Cedar Hill leading Colleyville Heritage, 10:07 to go. The winner of today's game, as we said, will take on McKinney Boyd High School next Saturday at 2 p.m. right here at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Colleyville Heritage comes to the line in the Wildcat formation as DeMarco Corbin. He's going to go straight up the pipe, and he is going to be stopped short as he tried to plunge over, but the middle of the Cedar Hill defense stopped him, and the two-point conversion is no good, and the Longhorns maintain their 37-18 lead.
And great job there of getting penetration up front by the Horns, doing a great job defending the run.
The officials get together, they confer, and they do say that the conversion attempt's no good. So when we come back, it'll be kickoff time for Colleyville Heritage. You're listening to Cedar Hill Longhorn Football on KBXB Dallas and the Champion Sports Network.
In Command Broadcasting, a sports TV broadcasting and marketing company. In Command Broadcasting provides a wide array of turnkey video production and streaming services. In Command services include filming of sporting events, season highlights, school graduations, corporate infomercials, and documentaries. In Command streams your sporting event or company function over the internet live or on demand. Call 972-851-7888 to raise the energy of your next event. In Command Broadcasting, 972-851-7888.
Back at Arlington, Texas at AT&T Stadium, Bill Howard, along with Cam Bowman, Cody Cram, and Trevor Williams, the Cedar Hill Longhorns with 10:07 to go in the football game, lead 37-18 over Colleyville Heritage. Colleyville Heritage will be kicking off. Longhorns have their hands team up front, looking probably expecting an onside kick here. Doing the kicking. Colleyville Heritage will be number one, Max
Howell. Yeah, and Cedar Hill has had a bit of an adventure sometimes on the onside kick, so it'll be important for the guys to not panic if the ball does come their way.
Max Howell, the kicker, waiting for the signal from the official. Longhorns trying to be prepared for this onside kick, and here it comes. It's a pooch kick up high, and it's recovered by Colleyville Heritage, but there's going to be interference against Colleyville Heritage and also, I believe, offsides against Colleyville Heritage, Cam.
Yeah,
that's
going
to negate that recovery.
Yeah, there were a couple of Colleyville Heritage players that were offsides, as you can see.
So there's going to be multiple penalties, I believe, against Heritage, which will allow Cedar Hill to get another opportunity. And Colleyville Heritage will have to kick the ball again. They did recover the onside kick.
Yeah, as I was saying earlier, it's a little bit of an adventure anytime we have an onside kick. But Cedar Hill really wasn't set up in a formation to be able to field the football against an onside kick.
They are going to re-kick. It is offsides. In today's kickoff, here in the fourth quarter with 10:01 to go, is brought to you by Buford Roofing and Construction. When you use Buford Roofing and Construction, you can consider yourself protected, and customer satisfaction is always guaranteed.
And DeMarco Corbin, as I was saying earlier, is actually over 150 yards as he has 19 carries, 162, and a touchdown. Let's see if the Longhorns will be able to kind of come out and do what they can to keep the ball away from Heritage.
Well, Cody, you were here last night and saw a big comeback by South Lake Carroll as they came back from a 17-point fourth-quarter deficit to defeat Mansfield. So the Longhorns need to keep playing hard.
Yeah, absolutely. In a game that it looked like Mansfield may have control of going into the fourth quarter, South Lake Carroll able to claw their way back into it. Cedar Hill has to be sure they don't allow momentum to swing back in the hands of Colleyville here.
Max Allen set to kick off. This time the Longhorns going to put six up front looking for the onside kick, and Allen kicks it deep and away. Ball's going to go into the end zone and out of the back of the end zone. And the Longhorns will have it first down and 10 at their own 25 when play resumes with 10:01 to go here in the fourth quarter, and the Longhorns leading 37-18. Scores from around the area last night, McKinney North beating Wakeland 24-21. As we told you, South Lake Carroll coming back to defeat Mansfield 38-31. And in a great game between South Oak Cliff and Lancaster. South Oak Cliff, a last second touchdown to beat Lancaster 37-34. From the 25-yard line on first down, the Longhorns hand it off inside to Aka Cedric Ware. He's going to take it across the 30 and down to the 33. And Cam, when you get a moment, let us know how Aka Cedric Ware is doing, because it has looked all day like the Colleyville Heritage Panthers have shut Haka Cedric down. But when you think that, you look at the stats, and he still gets great yardage. Second down and two from the 33. McMillan in the shotgun. They hand it off inside to Daniels to the 35, to the 40, all the way down to the 45-yard line. A flag comes in late. Got a lot of late flags after plays today. We'll have to see what this one is.
It's Cedar Hill again. Looks like they may have another penalty going against them. To your point earlier, Bill.
Now it's going to be a face mask, a personal foul variety against Heritage, so add 15 more on the Denver Daniels run.
Aka Cedric Ware, 24 carries, 94 yards, and 2 TDs. A really workman's like a 94 yard.
Averaging almost 4 yards a carry.
Yeah, and still putting up 2 touchdowns and really helping the Longhorns move forward.
Avery Davis, the sophomore, back in at quarterback now. He's straight back in the pocket. This is his first varsity pass. Throwing the ball deep downfield. Got DeMarcus Lodge, and it slips through his hands at the goal line. Oh, the sophomore Avery Davis threw a strike to the high school All-American DeMarcus Lodge. And Avery's going to have to let DeMarcus know about that one, because that ball was beautifully thrown right on the money, and it just slipped through at the goal line. DeMarcus Lodge's.
I was thinking about a touchdown, Dave.
He was indeed. I know I was. It's going to make it second down and 10. Avery Davis goes back to the sideline. McMillan back in as the quarterback. He keeps it on the option to the right, cuts it up inside, and it's going to be taken down at the 38 after a gain of 2. And, oh, Avery Davis, the sophomore, was about to make his first varsity pass, something very, very special.
Yeah, a touchdown, not only a touchdown, but a touchdown in the playoffs in Cowboys AT&T Stadium.
DeMarcus going to owe him a soft drink for that one. Second down and 8 from the 38. McMillan in the shotgun. Ware, the running back behind McMillan. Wide receivers to either side. Direct snap. Inside handoff to Aka Cedric. 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. All the way down to the 1 yard line before he's finally taken down by number 5, Reed Harrison DeCross. At the 1 yard line, giving 37 yards, which will put him well over the century mark. Longhorns quickly to the line. Ware in the Wildcat from the shotgun, going to walk in from the right side. He goes outside over the right tackle and scores another touchdown for Cedar Hill to extend their lead to 43-18.
And Coach McGuire told Aka Cedric Ware that he may need him to have 30 carries last week against South Grand Prairie. That wasn't necessary, or the game didn't allow that to happen, but he needed it today, and he's paying off.
The extra point attempt forthcoming from Brooks Routh. The Longhorns, with 8:06 to go in the game, have extended their lead to 43-18. And the extra point attempt is up and good by Brooks Routh. 8:06 to go in the fourth quarter. Cedar Hill 44, Colleyville Heritage 18. Cedar Hill Longhorn football on KDXD Dallas, the powerhouse of North Texas, and the Champion Sports Radio Network. We'll be back in a moment.
Writer Gerald Early said that when they study our civilization 2,000 years from now, there will only be 3 things that Americans will be known for: the Constitution, baseball, and jazz music. GDYO's Jazz Institute provides young musicians in North Texas the opportunity to learn what it means to be a jazz musician through weekly technique classes and combo rehearsals with professional jazz musicians. From the first note to the final round of applause, GDYO Jazz Institute concerts will amaze and delight both hardcore jazz cats and new fans alike. Learn more about the truly original American art form through the GDYO Jazz Institute online at gdyo.org/jazz.
On KDXD Dallas, 1480, the powerhouse of North Texas, and the Champion Sports Radio Network. I'm Bill Howard, along with Cam Boland, Cody Prim, Trevor Williams. 8:06 to go in the football game here at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. Cedar Hill leading Colleyville Heritage 44-18, and set to kick off. And Aka Cedric Ware, whose last 2 runs culminated in Cedar Hill points, is now up to 130 yards. The kickoff by Brooks Routh is fair caught by Colleyville Heritage at the 27-yard line by number 2, Nick Felix. and that's going to make it first down and 10. And it seems a long time ago, Cam, that Nick Felix intercepted Justin McMillan's pass in the first quarter, and the Longhorns were trailing 9-0, and everybody was a little uneasy. But since then, holy cow, Longhorns outscoring Colleyville Heritage 44-9.
Yeah, Cedar Hill, it almost seems like they needed to kind of get a kick in the pants to wake up. Maybe it was a start time a little earlier as they used to play in prime time, but ever since they really got things going.
Trevor Anderson, the quarterback in the shotgun. Toberty, the running back. Play action pass. Anderson straight back in the pocket, throwing the ball deep down the right sideline. Nobody there. Ball wasn't catchable, but there's going to be an interference penalty anyway against Cedar Hill, as great pressure on Anderson caused him to throw the ball early. Receiver trying to come out of his break, ran into a defensive back.
It almost seemed like that could be intentional grounding before it would be able to be pass interference.
Ball nowhere close to the receiver, but they don't call interference. Instead, they call holding against the Longhorns. That'll be a 10-yard penalty and a first down for Colleyville Heritage. That'll move the ball out to the 37-yard line. With 8 minutes to go in the football game, and Cedar Hill in control of this one, 44-18. Longhorns will take on McKinney Boyd, assuming they hold on to this large lead. That'll be next Saturday at 2 o'clock. Hope you're with us on Champion Sports Radio and KBXD Dallas. On first down and 10, Trevor Anderson fights the handoff inside. He'll keep it around the left side, across the 40, across the 45, and he gets all the way down to the 46-yard line. That's going to be enough for a first down on a 10-yard run by the quarterback, Trevor Anderson.
And a very good job of wrapping up the ball carrier at that time and forcing him to cut back, done by the safety, DeAndre Bradley.
Trips to the right, twins to the left. Anderson alone in the shotgun will throw. Straight back in the pocket. Here comes the pressure. He throws it over the middle. Got a man wide open at the 50, 45, 40, all the way down to the 35-yard line. Goes the Colleyville Heritage receiver. That's number 9, Camden Arnold. And that's going to be enough, well enough, for a first down for Colleyville Heritage. As a little extracurricular after the play is over. And Cedar Hill going to take a timeout. So are we. 7:08 to go in the game. Cedar Hill 44, Heritage 18. Cedar Hill football on KBXD Dallas. And the Champion Sports Radio Network will be back in a moment.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
Welcome back to AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. 7:08 to go in the ballgame. The Cedar Hill Longhorns leading Colleyville Heritage 44-18. Colleyville Heritage with a first down and 10 from the 35-yard line. Inside handoff to the first back through to number 22 for Colleyville Heritage, Justin Toberty. He's brought down for no gain, make it second down. Longhorns been in control of this one since about 2 minutes into the second quarter, finding themselves down 9-0. They turn the buzzsaw on, and the game has not been the same since. On second and 10, Trevor Anderson straight back in the pocket. I can't believe there's no holding call there, but there's not. The pass is complete out to the 22-yard line. And the ball is caught by number 4, Nelson Mohammed. And I'm telling you, number 15, Trevor Gibson, was completely tackled and wrestled to the ground. It was missed by the officiating crew, but it's okay. These officials do a great job week in and week out. on first down. Trevor Anderson's going to keep the ball on the quarterback, keep it around the left side, and he's going to take it all the way in for a touchdown for number six, the quarterback, Trevor Anderson. It looks like they snapped the ball a little quick there. They caught Cedar Hill trying to get players on and off the field.
Yeah, generally when you make substitutions on offense, the officials may stop and allow the defense time to make their substitutions as well.
Yeah, I don't think Colleyville substituted, though. I think it was Cedar Hill trying to substitute, and they got caught, and it's a touchdown for number six, Trevor Anderson, to make it 44-24, and a two-point conversion upcoming for Colleyville Heritage. In the Wildcat, shotgun formation is number 27, DeMarco Corbin, but before the ball can be snapped, we're going to get a delay of game penalty against Colleyville Heritage. So 44-24 is our score, 6:06 to go in the game. A game effort by Colleyville Heritage as they move down, get a touchdown with 6:06 to go here in the game, and they try to cut this lead to 18 points from the 20 that it currently is. They stay with DeMarco Corbin in the Wildcat. Motion across the formation. Corbin going to throw it. He's pulling it back. He's looking. He throws it into the end zone, and the ball's caught for the two-point conversion by number 9, Camden Arnold, to make it a 44-26 game. So with 6:06 to go in the game, Cedar Hill 44, Heritage 26, Longhorn football on KBHD and the Champion Sports Radio Network. Will be back in a moment.
Buford Roofing and Construction is a family-owned company you can trust. Buford Roofing specializes in roofing replacement and repair for the outside of your home or business and radiant barriers and insulation for the inside. They use top-quality materials, professionally trained crews, and guarantee total customer satisfaction. When you use Buford Roofing and Construction, you can consider yourself protected. They're online at BufordRoofing.com or call 817-329-ROOF.
KBXD, AM 1480, the powerhouse of North Texas, and Champion Sports Radio bring you today's first round playoff action with 6:06 to go in the fourth quarter here at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. A 22-yard touchdown run by quarterback Trevor Anderson and a two-point conversion for Colleyville Heritage has cut Cedar Hill's lead to 44-26. And again, we can expect an onside kick from Colleyville Heritage. Max Allen set to kick off. And he does not onside kick. He booms it away and it goes out of the back of the end zone. So the Longhorns will have it first down and 10 with 6:06 to go in the football game, leading 44-26. And the Longhorns will start moving right to left from their own 25-yard line.
And the Longhorns are already impressive on offense as it is so far. If they can sustain a drive here, keep the ball on the ground, keep the clock moving, they may be able to finally put the final nail in this coffin.
6:06 to go as the Longhorns start this drive here in the fourth quarter, leading by 18, 44-26. Ball's in the middle of the field, but Dylan has Akasedra Quares is running back behind him. Wide receivers to the other side. Blitz look from Heritage. Direct snap to McMillan. They hand it off inside to Ware. Correction, that's Jalen Jackson in for Ware. He gets to the 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, all the way down to the 47-yard line. Goes to sophomore Jalen Jackson, and Cedar Hill just keeps bringing people action.
Yeah, that's really disheartening for a defense, and it's kind of more wears you out as Desmond Duncan and Jared Williams really opened up ginormous hole for the young running back.
29-yard gain for the sophomore Jalen Jackson. McMillan first and 10 from the 46 of Colleyville Heritage, sends twins to the right and one to the left. Direct snap to McMillan. They hand it off inside again to Jackson. He makes one man miss, gets across the 45. They're going to mark it down right at the 45, about a yard and a half gain. Credit to tackle to number 26, Garrett Moffitt, who comes up from his defensive back position to make the tackle.
Yeah,
5:15 to go with the clock running. Second down and 8. McMillan keeping Jalen Jackson, the sophomore, in the game, giving Denver Daniels and Aka Cedric Ware some much-needed rest. Wide receivers to either side of the field. Direct snap to McMillan. He hands it off. No, he fakes it to Jackson. Straight back in the pocket. He's throwing the ball deep down the sideline, looking for the tight end, number 84, Josh Stewart, rather, the wide receiver. But the ball was well played, and the receiver was well covered. Number 2, Nick Felix, on the coverage. And Nick already has an interception to his credit today. Only the 3rd of the year thrown by quarterback Justin McMillan. Against 27 touchdown passes. McMillan back in the shotgun on 3rd down and 8. Jackson the running back. 4:52 to go in the game. Direct snap to McMillan. Inside handoff to Jalen Jackson. He cuts it up to the 40, 35, down to the 30. Stays on his feet and is taken down, but he fumbles the football at the 30-yard line, but the Longhorns are able to jump back on it at the 33. Credit the recovery there to number 62, the offensive lineman, Desmond Duncan, who saves the Cedar Hill drive from dying from a turnover. And it's a first down for the Longhorns with 4:25 to go as they now operate from the 33-yard line of Colleyville Heritage. Jackson stays in at running back. He's the eye back behind McMillan. Wide receivers to either side. Inside handoff to Jackson. He makes one man miss at the 30, and he gets down to the 29-yard line, giving 4 yards. You got to like the way Jalen Jackson, the sophomore, is coming in running the football.
Yeah, he's running really tough. And the main problem that Colleyville Heritage has kind of had today is actually tackling. If they've been in position a lot of times to make plays, they just haven't been able to bring down these hard-running senior ball carriers.
Second down and 6 for the Longhorns from the 29-yard line. McMillan in the shotgun. 3:40 to go in the game and the clock running. Inside handoff is to Elijah Moore, the I-back this time, and he's going to get down close to the 26-yard line, and that's going to lead the Longhorns looking at a 3rd down and about 3 yards to go. Elijah Moore's 2nd carry of the game, and the clock continues to run under 3:20 left in the game, and Cedar Hill has this one locked up. They lead Colleyville Heritage 44-26. Wide receivers to either side of the field. McMillan in the shotgun. Elijah Moore, the eye back. Direct snap, inside handoff to Moore, coming right to the 25, to the 20, gets down to the 15-yard line. That's going to be enough for a Cedar Hill Longhorn first down as the play clock goes inside 2:53 and continues to run in spite of the first down.
And you got to be impressed with how hard Cedar Hill and Colleyville both continue to play in this situation. Really impressive both sides.
Both teams having fantastic years to advance to the first round of the state playoffs. It looks at this point like Cedar Hill will continue on. If Colleyville Heritage will end with a 5-6 record if this holds. 2:24 to go in the clock running. Direct snap to McMillan on first down. Give it to Jackson to the 15, to the 10, to the 5. Jalen Jackson into the end zone for a touchdown. Oh, the sophomore Jalen Jackson goes 15 yards for a Cedar Hill touchdown, and the Longhorns have hit the half a 100 mark as they lead 50-26, awaiting the extra point attempt from Brooks Rao. The sophomore Jalen Jackson dominates that drive. The Longhorns extend their lead, and Brooks Rao's extra point is no good. He hooked it to the left, and with 2:11 to go, Cedar Hill 50, Colleyville Heritage 26, Longhorn football on KBXD Dallas and the Champion Sports Radio Network. We'll be back in a moment.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
KBXD, AM 1480, and the Champion Sports Radio Network back at AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, bringing you the Cedar Hill Longhorns first round playoff game against Colleyville Heritage. And the Longhorns, with 2:11 to go, lead 50-26. They will advance to round two, where they will play McKinney Boyd next Saturday afternoon, kickoff at 2 p.m. Our pregame show will start 30 minutes prior to kickoff. The kick from Brooks Ralph comes down to number two, Nick Felix. Felix takes it at the 20, goes across the 25 before he's brought down by a host of Longhorns at the 27-yard line. And let's take a moment to congratulate Colleyville Heritage and first-year coach Darren Allman. Darren, of course, a longtime coach, first at Lake Travis High School in Austin, before that at Odessa Permian. He has taken many teams deep into the playoffs. He is a coach that has enjoyed state championships. This is his first year at Colleyville Heritage, and his team has put up quite a fight here today, Cam.
Yeah, these guys really came out ready to play. They had a great game plan, which was obvious from the kickoff, and they really executed initially, just didn't have enough points in the game.
On first down, the handoff goes inside to DeMarco Corbin, and Corbin gets no gain on the play. He was wrestled back well behind the line of scrimmage, but they give him forward progress to the 25-yard line. That's going to make it a second down and 10, 1:35 to go, and the clock ticks on Colleyville Heritage's season. And before the ball can be snapped, Colleyville Heritage trying to get some substitutions into the game, Cam, are going to take a timeout. We'll keep it right here. Mack Hike Ford in DeSoto, where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling on I-35E between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads in DeSoto, bringing us Cedar Hill Longhorn football today. We want to thank Mack Hike. We also want to thank Buford Roofing and Construction, another fine sponsor for Cedar Hill Longhorn football on the Champion Sports Radio Network and KBXD Dallas, the powerhouse of North Texas. Well, this one looks to be in the bag, gentlemen. Longhorns lead 50-26. Another strong, hard-running football team awaits the Longhorns next week when McKinney Boyd comes to Arlington right here at AT&T Cowboys Stadium to take on Cedar Hill.
Yeah, one thing that I kind of look forward to seeing next week is, will the Longhorns be able to come out from the start and put the same type of effort and execution together as they have the second quarter of this game moving forward?
It'll be interesting to see. Resuming play, second and 10 from the right hash mark. Anderson in the shotgun will throw. Straight back in the pocket. He's throwing the ball deep down the seam. Got a man. Ball's complete at the 40. All the way down to the 35. All the way down to the 33-yard line. What a great throw from Trevor Anderson to the wide receiver, Camden Arnold, number 9. Straight down the seam. And that is going to be a 42-yard gain on the catch and throw from Trevor Anderson to the wide receiver, Camden Arnold. First down and 10. Clock stopped with 1:12. Inside handoff goes to DeMarco Corbin. He gets across the 30 down to the Cedar Hill 29 with 1:04 to go. And we've got another timeout by Colleyville Heritage, and this time we'll take a break too. 50-26, Cedar Hill leads, 1:04 to go in the fourth. Cedar Hill Longhorn football back on KBXD Dallas and Champion Sports Radio in a moment.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
Welcome back to Cedar Hill Longhorn football. 1:04 left in today's contest. Cedar Hill 50, Colleyville Heritage 26. Colleyville Heritage trying to make this a little more respectable. They're moving down the field against Cedar Hill's second team and third team defenders right now. They have a second down at the Cedar Hill 29. Trevor Anderson straight back in the pocket, looking. Gets away from one defender, but Cal Goss going to bring him down at the 31 for a sack.
And a great job by Travis Gibson as he forced, with his outside rush, the quarterback to take his eyes off of the receivers downfield and to step up in the pocket. That allowed Cal Goss to get the sack.
That's going
to
make it third down and eight with 40 seconds to go in the clock running. Anderson in the shotgun from the 30, trips to the right, one to the left. Anderson throws the bubble screen to the outside. It's complete to Toberny at the 25, down to the 20. He's taken down at the 17-yard line. And the clock's now down to 25 seconds. It stopped while they moved the chains as Colleyville Heritage picks up another first down. But now it starts again. Play clock inside 20 seconds. First down, ball at the Cedar Hill 18. Trevor Anderson in the shotgun sends twins to the right, trips to the left, and he'll throw. Straight back in the pocket. He's going to pull it down and try to run it. He just throws the ball out of bounds before taking a really tough shot in the backfield. And there's now 4 seconds left in the game. So we'll have time for probably just one more play, and the Cedar Hill Longhorns will advance, running their record to 10 wins and 2 defeats on the year. They will advance to round 2 of the Division II playoffs, where they will face McKinney Boyd. The season will come to an end for the Panthers at Colleyville Heritage. Their season will end at 5-6. With 4 seconds to go from the 18, Trevor Anderson in the shotgun takes the snap, and he's straight back in the pocket. Looking, he's throwing it over the middle. He's got a man to open it to 10, down to the 5, and the receiver is taken down by DeAndre Bradley at the 3, and that will end the football game. Our final score from Cowboys AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, the Cedar Hill Longhorns advance to round 2 of the state playoffs in Division II 6A as they defeat Colleyville Heritage 50-26. Longhorn football will wrap it up with postgame and statistics when we come back. You're listening to Cedar Hill Longhorn football on KBXD Dallas and the Champion Sports Radio Network.
This broadcast is under the direction and is copywritten by Champion Sports Radio. Any rebroadcast, retransmission, or use of the audio stream, and any and all other use of the accounts of this broadcast without the direct written consent and permission of Champion Sports Radio is strictly prohibited. All rights are reserved by Champion Sports Radio and championsportsradio.com. This is a presentation of Champion Sports Radio, your home for championship broadcasts.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
Buford Roofing and Construction is a family-owned company you can trust. Buford Roofing specializes in roofing replacement and repair for the outside of your home or business and radiant barriers and insulation for the inside. They use top-quality materials, professionally trained crews, and guarantee total customer satisfaction. Roofing and Construction is a family-owned company you can trust. Buford Roofing specializes in roofing replacement and repair for the outside of your home or business and radiant barriers and insulation.
Point of Origin Design is your one-stop shop for all your apparel, promotional, event, or team uniform needs. Point of Origin Design is a full-service design and logo creation company that offers a wide variety of imprintable and embroidered products. With competitive pricing and quality work, you can't go wrong with Point of Origin Design. It's always best to start at the right point, so visit them online at pointoforigindesign.com. Let them help you plan your next promotional item or design your next t-shirt. That's online at pointoforigindesign.com. In Command Broadcasting, a sports TV broadcasting and marketing company. In Command Broadcasting provides a wide array of turnkey video production and streaming services. In Command services include filming of sporting events, season highlights, school graduations, corporate infomercials, and documentaries. In Command streams your sporting event or company function over the internet live or on demand. Call 972-851-7888 to raise the energy of your next event. In Command Broadcasting, 972-851-7888.
Writer Gerald Early said that when they study our civilization 2,000 years from now, there will only be three things that Americans will be known for: the Constitution, baseball, and jazz music. GDYO's Jazz Institute provides young musicians in North Texas the opportunity to learn what it means to be a jazz musician through weekly technique classes and combo rehearsals with professional jazz musicians. From the first note to the final round of applause, GDYO Jazz Institute concerts will amaze and delight both hardcore jazz cats and new fans alike. Learn more about the truly original American art form through the GDYO Jazz Institute online at gdyo.org/jazz.
There's a time and a place for everything.
As you'll see, projections for the next quarter are...
He shoots, he scores! 2 points for team middle management.
The office is not one of them.
Jack, can I see you in my office?
No pouting, it's your ball, let's see what you got.
But Whirly Ball is.
For corporate events, team building, and private parties, Whirly Ball in Hearst and Plano is electric fun. Test your skills on the arcade games. Zip around in your Whirly Bug for a Whirly Ball competition. Or play the most affordable laser tag in the city. Learn more at whirlyball.info.
Welcome back to the Cedar Hill Longhorn postgame show. The Cedar Hill Longhorns victorious today over the Heritage Panthers from Colleyville. They defeat Colleyville Heritage 50-26. Longhorns fall behind early today, 9-0 in the first quarter. And everybody on the Cedar Hill side just a little bit nervous. But once the second period started, the Cedar Hill Longhorns took over and controlled the football game for the remaining three periods. Got to tip your hat, though, to Colleyville Heritage, guys. A super effort, a super job by Darren Allman and his staff and the Panthers of Colleyville Heritage. And statistically, they had some players that put up some good numbers. Why don't, Cam, you run us through the Colleyville Heritage statistics?
Yeah, Colleyville Heritage finished with 391 total yards and 19 first downs. They had 201 rushing yards on 34 attempts, and that's over 5 yards a carry, nearly 6 yards per carry. Trevor Anderson, the quarterback, really did have an efficient game as well, as he was able to kind of keep things interesting, as he had 190 yards passing out of 13 to 25, his attempt was one touchdown. DeMarco Corbin, the Northern Illinois commit, 162 yards on 4 attempts, 71-7 per carry with a touchdown. And Camden Arnold, really a good day outside, 7 catches, 140 yards, and a touchdown. So again, Cedar Hill able to pull out a victory, 50-26 in Colleyville Heritage here at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. When we come back, we'll have some additional.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
Buford Roofing and Construction is a family-owned company you can trust. Buford Roofing specializes in roofing replacement and repair for the outside of your home or business and radiant barriers and insulation for the inside. They use top quality materials, professionally trained crews, and guarantee total customer satisfaction. When you use Buford Roofing and Construction, you can consider yourself protected. They're online at BufordRoofing.com or call 817-329-ROOF.
Stay up on all the latest news about the teams you care about and know when your favorite games are on the air thanks to Champion Sports Radio social media. Either follow at Champion Sports on Twitter or like our Facebook page at facebook.com/Champion Sports Radio, and you will know what time your game starts, who was named Player of the Week, or what your school's alumni are doing in college. That's on Twitter at Champion Sports and facebook.com/Champion Sports Radio. Your home for championship social media.
Many heart conditions can be fixed, but many of us don't know we have a problem until it's too late.
On April 2, 2009, Zachary Schraw, a 16-year-old sophomore offensive lineman, died of sudden cardiac arrest, the number one cause of death among student athletes. Like so many SCA victims, Zach had no heart issues, nor did anyone in his family. If Zach had an echocardiogram, he might have been able to avoid suffering a condition that takes 10,000 of our youth each year. In his memory, Living for Zachary was formed to try and prevent SCA from taking the lives of youth everywhere. Join in the fight today and stop the silent killer of SCA by scheduling your young athlete for an echocardiogram, a procedure that can detect any heart issue with 99% accuracy. For more information, visit www.livingforzachary.org. That's living, the number four, Zachary.org, and let your heart be heard.
Are you tired of only spending time as a family huddled around the TV? Would you like to enjoy some culture with your loved ones without breaking the bank? Then let me introduce you to the Greater Dallas Youth Orchestra. The GDYO provides music education and performance opportunities for musically talented youth, but this is no kids' concert. The GDYO comprises seven different ensembles made up of over 425 talented musicians ages 8 to 18, representing more than 50 communities in North Texas. You won't believe how amazing these ensembles sound until you hear it for yourself. So join them for one of their concerts at the Meyerson Symphony Center or Dallas City Performance Hall. For more information on how to make a donation, as well as a listing of upcoming GDYO concerts, visit gdyo.org. And if you know a talented young musician interested in an unbelievable experience, auditions take place in the spring. Connect with the Greater Dallas Youth Orchestra on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and at gdyo.org.
Welcome back to the Cedar Hill Longhorn Postgame Show on KBXD Dallas. 1480, the powerhouse of North Texas, and the Champion Sports Radio Network. The Cedar Hill Longhorns defeat the Colleyville Heritage Panthers today 50-26. The Longhorns, by virtue of this win, will advance to round two of the Division II 6A Texas High School State Playoffs. They will play McKinney Boyd next Saturday, kickoff at 2 p.m. Hope you're here joining us on KBXD and the Champion Sports Radio Network for our pregame show 30 minutes prior to kickoff. The Cedar Hill Longhorns' victory today had many stars. Longhorn defense giving up a touchdown early in the game, but really keeping Colleyville Heritage completely at bay, Cam, Cody, until the game was out of reach and a lot of reserves on both sides started playing. And The score got a little bit closer after that, but there was no doubt during the second half, Cedar Hill dominated. And they dominated with stars on defense like Richard Moore, Clifton Coffey, the big nose tackle, had an excellent game. So did Jalen Pitt, the defensive end, had a great football game too. Longhorns come up with big plays on defense, but Cam, Cody, you know when we talk about Cedar Hill Longhorn football, we're talking about the offensive side of the ball. And they put up some monster numbers today. Cody Krim, why don't you take us through those Cedar Hill statistics?
Yeah, Cedar Hill coming up with an astonishing 586 yards of total offense, Cam. They had 52 rushes for 429 yards. That mainly on the legs of Daniels and Ware, who went on a running back kind of committee, sharing a lot of the carries. Daniels leading the way with 138 yards and a touchdown. Ware having 131 yards and three touchdowns, both having good games on the ground. Something that we had seen a little bit prior to this game was Ware in the Wildcat running the ball out of the Wildcat, but we hadn't seen as much as we did today. It seemed as though every fourth down, whether it's fourth and three, fourth and four, fourth and inches, wherever they were on the field, it didn't matter. Own territory, Colleyville territory, they relied on Ware back in the Wildcat to pick up that short yardage play. You think that was something they saw on film, or is that something that we may continue to see throughout the playoffs? You remember last year, they kind of went to a quick snap in the playoffs on fourth down. Do you think the Wildcat from Ware is going to see something we see repeated?
I think that will be something that we continue to see here in the playoffs. You can never know with those plays, just like you came out today. Play action pass plays.
made this the last year in the playoffs, every game, out of the wild pass. I'm sure plays may come out with something different. But, I mean, if you got a guy that's, like I said, Ware, why would you not give it to him?
Exactly. And that's, Ware is just one of the big playmakers, USC commit, big-time Division I level prospect, and he showed why today. Justin McMillan, another Division I recruit, the LSU commit, had eight completions on 13 attempts, 157 yards, a touchdown. He did have the interception early. He also picked up 76 yards and a big touchdown on the ground. McMillan really seemed to rebound, if you will, after that interception he threw early. Cam really came and bounced back, had a few more easy completions. They did eventually get Lodge involved in the game. He had four receptions for 107 yards and a touchdown. And then the monster reception by Harper, by Darius Harper, the one catch he had on the day for 43 yards where he went up over the defender and got it. Really a great game for McMillan. The stats don't necessarily show that he did a whole lot, but he did a whole lot after the initial interception and protected the ball, keeping drives going on the ground, and most important, leading the Sawhorn into victory.
Chime, come here, I can chime in real quick on Justin McMillan's play. You know, Justin, sometimes we have a tendency to expect so much out of Justin McMillan. And you know, when you're as great a quarterback as he is, and LSU's getting a steal down in Baton Rouge when he heads that way next year. But a lot of times when he does good, it doesn't look as good as it is because so often he's so great. And the play that you're talking about at the end of the first half on the great catch by Darius Harper, I thought was one of the key plays in the football game. If Colleyville Heritage can stop Cedar Hill from scoring there, knowing Cedar Hill's going to get the ball to start the second half, they could have gained some momentum. But Harper's great catch, Cam, and it was a fantastic catch. But he only gets to make that fantastic catch if his quarterback, Justin McMillan, gets him an opportunity.
Yeah, and those explosive plays throughout the course of games are really backbreakers and momentum swingers. So to go into the half immediately after having such a tremendous play made by one of the playmakers really gave Cedar Hill an extra boost and really a firm grasp on the momentum moving forward in the ball game.
Didn't mean to step on your statistics. Cody, you go right ahead and pick up.
No, perfectly fine. To continue on with the point that y'all just made, to end the half, let's also give credit to Brooks Ralph. You know that it's playoff time, baby, when CNA Pants comes up and booms through a 35-yarder with ease. All the woes seem to be gone in the kicking game. He did miss a extra point on the final touchdown, but nonetheless a great game by Skinny Pants Brooks Ralph, Cam.
Yeah, Brooks Ralph, good to see that kid have a little bit of success as he's finally going a little bit rough here in the last month or so of the season. Really kind of throughout the season it's been kind of tough on him, so I'm really happy to see him have some success again because he's contributed a lot to the Cedar Hill Longhorn program and helped them earn their way into a couple of state championships and win one.
And absolutely. I mean, going back 2 years ago, he was the MVP of the state semifinal game where he made a 40-plus yard field goal to beat Austin Westlake in the semifinals to lead them to advance onto the state championship. A couple more points I'd like to touch on before we head out. I was really impressed with Jalen Jackson. When he got the ball, really hard running the ball. It may be a situation where we see him getting the ball a little more as we go throughout the playoffs. And also a great spark by Denver Daniels. I think we're going to see a lot more of Denver Daniels and Jalen Jackson, and that's just going to be more options that that defenses in the future are going to have to worry about.
Well, the Longhorns are 50-26 winner today over Colleyville Heritage, The Panthers put up a game fight for a while, but in the end, not enough. So glad you were with Champion Sports Radio. KBXD AM 1480. We'll take it down. Let's do our sponsors a couple more times, and then we'll get back and wrap this one up from AT&T Stadium.
Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is a place where you can get that great Mack Hike feeling during Mack Hike Ford's year-end celebration. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is in the heart of sunny South Dallas County on I-30 East between Pleasant Run and Beltline Roads, just minutes from downtown Dallas. You can also check out great deals on new and pre-owned vehicles online at MackHikeDeSoto.com. That's MackHikeDeSoto.com. Mack Hike Ford DeSoto is proud to be a supporter of local high school academic and athletic activities.
Shell experts here with a pitching machine and a shield to demonstrate the importance of protecting your engine.
Think of me as an engine. The shield is new Shell gasoline with 20% more nitrogen and rich cleaning agents than before.
And the baseballs are gunk that attack intake valves and fuel injectors.
Come on, gunk, is that all you got?
Gunk is out of here!
New Shell nitrogen-enriched gasolines. No other gasoline protects your engine better.
For quality auto service and repair, see the folks at Flat Shell on Preston Road at I-635.
In Command Broadcasting, a sports TV broadcasting and marketing company. In Command Broadcasting provides a wide array of turnkey video production and streaming services. In Command services include filming of sporting events, season highlights, school graduations, corporate infomercials, and documentaries. In Command streams your sporting event or company function over the internet live or on demand. Call 972-851-7888 to raise the energy of your next event. In Command Broadcasting, 972-851-7888.
Writer Gerald Early said that when they study our civilization 2,000 years from now, there will only be three things that Americans will be known for: the Constitution, baseball, and jazz music. GDYO's Jazz Institute provides young musicians in North Texas the opportunity to learn what it means to be a jazz musician through weekly technique classes and combo rehearsals with professional jazz musicians. From the first note to the final round of applause, GDYO Jazz Institute concerts will amaze and delight both hardcore jazz cats and new fans alike. Learn more about the truly original American art form through the GDYO Jazz Institute online at gdyo.org/jazz.
There's a time and a place for everything.
As you'll see, projections for the next quarter are...
He shoots, he scores! 2 points for team middle management.
The office is not one of them.
Jack, can I see you in my office?
No pouting, it's your ball, let's see what you got.
But Whirlyball is. For corporate events, team building, and private parties, Whirlyball in Hearst and Plano is electric fun. Test your skills on the arcade games. Zip around in your Whirlybug for a Whirlyball competition. Or play the most affordable laser tag in the city. Learn more at whirlyball.info.
Point of Origin Design is your one-stop shop for all your apparel, promotional, event, or team uniform needs. Point of Origin Design is a full-service design and logo creation company that offers a wide variety of imprintable and embroidered products. With competitive pricing and quality work, you can't go wrong with Point of Origin Design. It's always best to start at the right point. So visit them online at pointoforigindesign.com. Let them help you plan your next promotional item or design your next t-shirt. That's online at pointoforigindesign.com.
Back on the Cedar Hill Longhorn postgame show, the Cedar Hill Longhorns advanced to round two of the Division II 6A state high school playoffs with a 50-26 victory over the Colleyville Heritage Panthers. The road gets no easier for our Longhorns next week at 2 p.m. right here at AT&T Stadium. They take on McKinney Boyd. A 42-23 victory over Keller Fossil Ridge last night, and they were faced by senior running back Kendrick Scrivens, who rushed the ball 34 times for 225 yards. So the Longhorns will fix what ails them on defense. They'll continue to work to get better on offense, and they'll be back here next Saturday at 2 p.m. for the kickoff. We'll be here 30 minutes prior to kickoff on KBXD. AM Radio 1480, the powerhouse in North Texas, and Champion Sports Radio Network. For everyone that helped us put this one on today, as well as my broadcast team, Cody Prim, Cam Bowman, spotter Trevor Worthy,
We say so long from AT&T Stadium. Our final score, Cedar Hill 50, Colleyville Heritage 26. It's my last time.